11 stuck there, 5 of 15. Giannis with it. In the damn Adebayo. Short picked up by Adebayo. Here comes Lowry. It's Jimmy Butler. Screen. This is for the tie. Martin saves it. Butler's got it. Martin with Giannis there. It's a two. One-point game.
Was trying to call timeout, but Kyle Lowry and his intensity and defense created another turnover.
In this series, Butler has scored 35 points, 25 points, 30 points, and tonight 44.
But how about the efficiency? 17 of 26.
It's Middleton with the ball. Lowry on him. Giannis in the hand. Sidestepping, falling, score! What a play for the lead. Giannis puts it up and in.
Did you see how long those strides were by the Greek freak? Look at this. One, two. I mean, and taking Bam with him. He took Bam for a ride right here.
1 of 3 from the line. Miami has 15 wins this season after trailing through three quarters. It's the most in the NBA. Like you said, they've been hanging around, and sure enough, moments ago took their first lead. But Giannis will try to make it a three-point play, and does. And Milwaukee's lead is back to two.
Isolation basketball. Well, last 3 minutes.
They'll take it in. Out to Martin. Fakes it. Now fires. Cut it. It's a three for the lead. Caleb Martin.
How big has Martin been here in this fourth quarter? At both ends.
10 points in the quarter. Middleton slips, saves the ball. Holiday the leaping catch. Step back, triple, bullseye. And now Milwaukee's recaptured the lead.
Oh my goodness, this is becoming an old-fashioned shootout here. Wow.
Lowry trying to work his way in. Middleton's in front. Shot clock at 9. He'll accelerate and feed, and nobody home. Another turnover, and Lowry's had a couple here late in the game.
He was expecting a dribble handoff with Duncan. Duncan wanted to go back door to that three-point line.
Milwaukee trying to tie the series. Middleton, triple. Rebound fought for. It's out of bounds. It is Miami's ball. Timeouts apiece. Can the 8 seed go up 3-1 on the 1 seed?
Butler's got to go quick.
Butler does. Sets up over Holiday. Got a hand on the cocked right shooting arm. Holiday picks up the foul.
In the playoffs.
There are a few players that are playing at the level that Butler has played in these playoffs.
In my open, I said he's arguably the best player early on in these playoffs. And you can put Devin Booker's name in there, De'Aaron Fox, but Jimmy Butler certainly at the top of everyone's list.
To tie.
And clutch on top of that, right?
Two ties, 4 lead changes. And the Bucks with the ball.
And not a soul sitting in their seat.
The Gumbo to Lopez, and he'll slam it with the flush, and it's a 2-point puck lead.
There's just no size out here for Miami. They've got to play small. And every time Lopez is going to roll down the middle, you've got a guard rotating over to him. He doesn't even feel him.
46 points for Jimmy Butler. Sets up a 3-point.
Why not? Why not Jimmy Butler.
Butler's got 49 points. 14 in the fourth quarter. Giannis drives, spins, fires. No! Butler. Long shot. Good! Scores correct. Giannis with the ball. Outside, Howard. Lost it, pickpocketed by Lowry. Lowry stole the ball. Jimmy Butler the other way. Fouled.
Teams in playoff history have come back from that kind of deficit. But this is an 8 against a 1. And Butler's got 52.
Of the Bucks
led it 101-89 with 6 minutes to play.
How many does Jimmy Butler have?
52 points.
Of the 113 points.
It's been as great a playoff performance as we have seen individually by Butler. And it's 53 and counting. Connaughton. And Giannis Antetokounmpo with the triple-double. Galloping the other way, and the Bam out of bounds. Oh, no! Rebound by Butler! It's Butler to Bam. Holiday the foul. 32 seconds to go.
Lonzo Mourning. He might echo that. I'm not talking about player. I'm talking about greatest single performance in a playoff game.
Timeout Milwaukee. When Butler came back in the game, a big run. It's Ingles in the corner, Holiday. It's a three-point shot, short, rebound Ingles, another three, Holiday, no. Rebound out of bounds, off the rim, a foul on the Heat. Love will come in the game for the first time in a long time for Miami. Joining Butler, Adebayo, Lowry, and Vincent. The last 5.5 minutes, a 27-10 Miami run. Full court butt pressure. It's off to Vincent, now Lowry, and ahead to Butler. Foul by Allen.
That's... There's that. New career high for Jimmy Butler in any game, regular season or playoffs.
18 to 22 from the line, Miami. 17 to 20, Milwaukee at the line. 13 threes for Miami, 12 for the Bucks. Trailing 2-1 to the 8th seed. Butler's put in 20 points in an explosive fourth quarter. Giannis. It's Lopez, Butler there, three off the glass and in! What a shot by Lopez! Butler, Lowry, 8.4 in a four-point game.
Milwaukee with a timeout.
And Miami with a timeout, and Butler from the line is 15 of 17 tonight. Giannis, five-point game. Antetokounmpo lost the ball. It's loose. Miami's going to win it. Miami has won it and goes up 3-1. And the number one seed is on the brink of elimination.
Brand new game. Here comes Bam. Downhill. A Bam slam. big time. 111-109. What a game. Second time the Heat Warriors have turned in an instant classic this year. 2.5 weeks ago.
There's no size. They go small on this Golden State lineup to get back in the game. The rim is unprotected and can be attacked.
So Dragic, Jones Jr., and Josh Richardson all with 5 Miami fouls. Curry, quick three, and he missed it. Bam comes down with his 11th rebound of the game. 2-point Heat lead. We're in crunch time. 4:21 and counting left. Home crowd enjoying it. We hope you are too. Oh, Richardson got pushed as he does points. And a stoic Steve Kerr. Now sit in his seat, letting it all unfold. Richardson, open three. Kaboom! Somebody got to go out and guard him. 4 triples in the second half and 5 for 6 shooting from downtown tonight for Richardson.
Gaged right now, wanting to see their Heat team upset this champion, defending champion.
Now feels like the playoff stage
right
now.
It does.
Use your imagination over the final 4 minutes with a Heat ahead by 5. Klay Thompson got fouled on the 3 by Waiters and made it. He's unbelievable, has 32 points.
Going on those down screens, taking away that quick catch and shoot, whether it's Durant or Klay Thompson. Thompson's the one with the hot hand. He is 6 of 13 now beyond the arc. He's got 33 points.
Thompson had 29 on the first matchup against Miami. It's a 1-point Heat lead with 3:38 left in the game. Bam, in a crowd, draws a foul.
6'7", and KD at 6'9", who really, you know, plays more of a small forward position. So there is the opportunity with an aggressive post-up to get a good look.
Wade in, Waiters out with 3:36 left. Don't forget to be with us right after the game for our Heat Live post-game presented by Duncan. Jax will be joined by Ron Rothstein and Ruth Riley Hunter for the most comprehensive post-game show in the NBA. Now Bam Adebayo misses both free throws. Heat are 22 of 28 at the stripe. Well, they needed those two. Their lead is 1. Warriors' last lead came with just under 10 minutes left in the first quarter when it was 7-4. Thompson gives the Warriors the lead. He has their last 7 points.
And he's feeling good. Thompson, 7 of 14 now beyond the arc.
His 10th game this year, over 30 points. What a beautiful pass. Bam to the cutting Richardson. Richardson has 8 points in the fourth quarter and 21 for the game. A game that's now tied with 3 minutes to play.
Excellent execution. Just great basketball there on the overplay. Jay Rich in the backup.
Thompson again. Wade pulls down the rebound. Well, when Thompson shoots, you just hold your breath and hope. He's 7 of 15 from downtown. 2:40 left. And Richardson called for traveling.
Get back, regroup defensively, and match up.
A couple former Heat players in the house tonight. Jamal Mashburn and Mario Chalmers both in the building. 2.5 minutes left. Here comes Curry. Bam, blocked it. Curry still scored.
Oh, my. He did. He got a deflection on that ball. He got a fingertip on it. Somehow it still went in off the glass.
24 for Curry. And a foul here on Draymond Green. Record in the postseason, 63 wins, just 20 losses. That's how you win 3 of the last 4 titles. Olynyk from downtown. Wade with a rebound. 2:02 left in the game. Warriors ahead by 2. Wade gets a great screen from Bam and delivers. A back shot for Wade gives him 19, ties the game at 118. Well, we were tied at 116, now we're tied at 118 with under 2 minutes left. Loose ball, Winslow has it go out of bounds. Tonight, 118 to 113. Washington's leading Brooklyn with 2 seconds left, 125 to 116. And the Pistons are trailing at San Antonio by 5. 7 on the shot clock here. This is Curry against Bam. Don't foul. Curry loses the ball to Winslow. Richardson has it, and the Heat have the ball in a tight game with 1:30 to play. What a finish. Richardson from downtown. And the rebound in traffic to Durant. That would have given the Heat the lead. We're still tied at a buck 18.
Pretty good look at it. Had some space.
Durant straight away three. And the foul on Bam. Uh-oh.
Even though he's struggling, 2 of 11 beyond the arc to get to that three ball there to make his third one. 3 out of 12 attempts.
Left. It'll be Winslow to inbound. He's got Adebayo, Olynyk, Wade, and Richardson with him. Wade against Iguodala. Olynyk motors in, gets it to Bam, and he was stopped.
Wonderful free throws. There you go, big fella.
Bam is 4 of 8 from the free throw line, has his 6th double-double of the season with 10 points, 10 rebounds. He also has 4 assists. Now it's a final. Washington wins at Brooklyn, 125 to 116. That ends a 2-game winning streak for Brooklyn, and it also ends a 4-game losing streak for the Wizards. So the Nets are now 32 and 31. It's a 2-point game here in Miami. 46 seconds to play. Shot clock at 8. This is Thompson. Ball deflected. Goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Warriors with 6 seconds on the shot clock. And Steve Kerr wants to draw something up. He asks for timeout. This is Durant against Bam. Deflection. Loose ball. Stolen by Olynyk. The Heat have a chance. 30 seconds left. Down by 2. Get on your feet. Olynyk from downtown. Oh my, the Heat had a golden opportunity to take a 1-point lead on a wide open Olynyk triple. And in the corner, the foul was against Miami's Justice Winslow. He's 4 of 8 from the line. Made a big one there. Jordan Bell, a 24-year-old, second round pick a couple years ago. He has 8 points tonight.
He'd have one timeout. I think Coach Spo may opt to let it run it out here and go down the floor. Well, he's going to call the timeout here with that make
this game. Winslow in the wave. 3 on the way. Got it! 124-123. And the Heat fouled Durant. Well, 2 big ones here for Durant. He missed the first.
Oh, my. 89%. Even a 4-time scoring champ and MVP feels the pressure.
Made the second. It's a 2-point lead for the Warriors. Heat need a 3 to win. 10 seconds left. Wade against Iguodala. 5 seconds left. Waiters back to Dwayne. Shoots. No, he couldn't get it off. Now fires it up. Bank it in. It counts. It counts. The Heat win the game. Dwayne Wade won it for Miami. 126 to 125. It just happened.
James with 6 to shoot. Danny Green for 3. Comes up short, the tip misses. Players down on the floor, shaken up. Tyler Hero. Lakers have a couple of players down on the backcourt. Adebayo lays it up and in. And Caldwell Pope finally got up. He was knocked down, stayed down for a while. Davis is shaken up. Neither one of them crossed half court as Miami's back within 1.
Tell you, the Lakers right now, they're getting great looks offensively.
And they're just going to keep putting the smalls, Duncan Robinson and Hero, in the pick and roll.
James against Butler. Drives, gets inside, stops, blocked by Butler. Rejected out of bounds with 4.2 left on the shot clock. James looking, finds Caruso. Caruso fakes and stolen by Butler. Coming up on 3.5 remaining. Butler drives, draws the foul. Count it and 1. The Lakers trying to say that the basket shouldn't have counted. The officials are conferring.
They wiped it off.
It looked like one official said count it, but another one wiping it off. And they're going to take it out of bounds. It's the 14th foul on the Lakers, 3rd on Morris.
Miami ball to the side.
Boy, that's very close to being in the upward motion. Butler guarded by Morris. Shot clock at four. Butler drives, stops. Up top, Robinson puts up a three. It's good! It's good! Duncan Robinson from downtown! And the Heat back on top by two.
As Butler's isolating, Robinson's man staring at the ball. Robinson, great job relocating.
Caldwell Pulp looks to answer. Cannot. The tip won't go, but a foul.
And will this be shooting? Is it a controlled tap?
Third team foul on Miami. Caruso to James. James gets fouled. Still gets the shot off as they grab his arm.
Once again, shows his versatility as a roller.
Free throw from James is good. The upcoming NBA Finals scheduled, if necessary, on Sunday. Game 6 tip-off would be shortly after 7:30. A Game 7 would be Tuesday. Right now, it's up in the air. 2:52 remaining. Two big free throws there from LeBron James. Now has 35 points, 11 rebounds, 7 assists, and we're all tied up.
This is where Tyler Hero has to be assertive.
Now Morris switches up on Butler. Butler the drive, floats it up, shot won't go, and the rebound goes to the Lakers. Looked like it was going to take a lucky bounce for the Heat.
And Anthony Davis hobbling, running up the floor.
He's been hobbling a bit the last couple of minutes. A limp more pronounced now. James finds Caldwell Pope, three-pointer. In and out, fight for the rebound, knock loose, Butler to save it. Finds Tyler Hero. A thriller here in game five.
Watch 2 minutes to play.
Adebayo looking, back to Robinson, up top to Butler. Butler pulls up, got it! Jimmy Butler does it again, and the Heat take a two-point lead. James looking, now Crowder switches on him. James drives, gets inside, running layup, it's good, and a foul! LeBron James ties the game. And James completes the three-point play. He's got 38. Lakers up by one, a minute and a half away from a championship. But here comes Jimmy Butler in the Heat. Butler one-on-one with Markieff Morris. Butler drives, falling away, got it again! Jimmy Butler puts the Heat back up by one.
Anybody but LeBron James here.
James and Butler. James drives, goes inside, layup, missed it, got the rebound, the follow, he banks it home.
To me, if I'm Miami, on the next possession, I'm getting the ball out of his hands. That ball's got to swing to somebody else.
James and Butler throwing haymakers at each other. Butler drives, and he's fouled. And Butler right now is exhausted with 46.7 remaining.
You know, Mike, during the timeout, coach talked to me and he said, one thing I do if I'm Eric Spoelstra is get Andre Iguodala in the ball game. He is an elite defender, extremely high IQ, gives you the best chance, whether it be as a primary defender on James or as a helper.
Butler two, clutch free throws, the Heat back up by one.
And I'm not worried about the three being up one. I'm coming to get LeBron James in a double team. It's going to be Caruso that has to beat me.
Both teams in the penalty. Both teams one timeout remaining. James guarded by Butler. Posting him up, backing in, looking. Kicks it out, pass deflected. Caldwell Pope for three. No good. Davis on the follow, and he lays it in as the shot clock expires. Lakers up one. 21 seconds remaining. They're going to review to make sure that the shot came before the shot clock expired.
James is on him. Maybe his best opportunity.
What drama here at the end of game five. Crowder will inbound. Robinson, Hero, Butler, and Adebayo out there for Miami.
And if you're Hero, Robinson, you got to put yourself in position, be ready to catch and knock down a shot.
Into the hands, of course, to Jimmy Butler. Butler goes to the basket, layup, won't go, but a foul.
But that's exactly what I was talking about. Don't let him off the hook by taking a jump shot. You can't end your season that way. Solid screen by Crowder, turns the corner, gets the contact, and going to the line to put his team up one.
And everybody talks about verticality. That's not vertical. You see where Anthony Davis started his jump and ended his jump. He jumped into him. That's a good call.
Third foul on Davis. Butler with a remarkable ability to get to the free throw line. And connects again. 34 points for Jimmy Butler.
You see where Davis takes off, jumping to his left, and no timeout, or will they take a timeout if you're LA?
It looks like they will.
Butler, clutch free throw after clutch free throw. Heat up by one, but still plenty of time remaining.
They're going to try to get Duncan Robinson in the action.
Green into the hands of LeBron James. Butler on him. Green coming up to set a screen. James goes the other way. Drives down a lane. Back out to Green. Green for three. Off the mark. No good. Marquise Morris has it. Throws it inside and throws it out of bounds. With 2.2 remaining.
But they have to get it in, Mike.
No timeouts.
And where is everybody going? If you're Miami.
They tried to lob it into Davis.
Who's your inbounder?
That's why I would have left Andre Iguodala in the ball game as an inbounder.
So Crowder will inbound. Morris trying to distract him. Crowder looking inside to Hero, and he's fouled immediately with 1.6 left. Way. Hero's, as you see, first free throws of the night.
And here's the question: if you're Miami, if he makes it, do you put somebody on the ball? If he misses it, it's going to be a desperation heave anyway.
And the interesting thing moving forward, Anthony Davis is clearly not 100%. If Miami is fortunate enough to finish this ball game off, you can make a case to miss this shot, coach.
You could.
It'd be very difficult to try and track down the rebound as opposed to take it out of bounds and take your time to throw it down the floor and get a good look. Hero completes it.
And I'm sprinting back, double teaming LeBron James. I'm not allowing him or Davis to catch the ball on the fly.
Yeah.
Lakers.
Yeah. Iguodala is in no man's land right now. He either should be up on the ball or in front of Davis and James.
Lakers need a three to tie. Rondo looking for an opening. Rifles a pass to James. James gets off the three. It's over. The Heat take every punch and refuse to surrender. There'll be a game six. Jimmy Butler with another masterpiece.
Number one clutch team in the association.
Look at the pass there.
Great back door. Robinson got the feed from on top. 9-2 Miami run.
And it was Max Strus for the Heat in the game one in the second half. Now it's Duncan Robinson in game two.
I think you have to switch that back screen. You can't give up the layup.
Greg Williams three. It's picked up by Brown. Three defenders around. They all were swiping at the ball. Here comes Butler the other way. A chance to tie. Here's the lead for three. No. And the collision is Smart, who's down. Smart is down. Butler was fouled to the line.
The foul's on Jimmy Butler.
On Jimmy Butler.
Which created that offensive foul on Butler.
It's the first foul on Butler and four to play in the fourth. In a two-point game in game two. Horford a screen. Tatum makes a move and finds Williams.
They are absolutely destroying them on that high screen and roll.
And that's against the zone, but Tatum able to get into the paint and make the play. That was the play that wore out Philadelphia in the second half of game seven.
against Horford Adebayo, and there's the foul on Al. Free throw percentage this year by Adebayo. Here comes Max Strus. Timeout, Boston.
Two tonight in this fourth quarter, both were threes. But again, Coach, you're right. He's been facilitating and making sure the Celtics continue to stay aggressive here in the fourth.
Miami two fouls to give. Boston none. Martin is on Tatum. Grant Williams against Adebayo. Bam's got the rebound. Number 13.
Chance to tie with a two or go up one with a three.
Butler drives on Grant Williams and a 15-footer will tie it at 100.
He's just going at Grant Williams every chance he gets.
Oh, terrible. We saw it the other night. 13-4 run Miami. A chance for the lead here. Butler's got 25. Adebayo screen. Williams the defensive assignment.
This is what he wants.
Inside for the lead. He got it.
That's what he wants. Grant Williams on him.
The Celtics are going to have to come and double. You just can't watch Jimmy Butler wear you out and win the game going one-on-one.
Smart. Open three. Rebound Horford. He shoves Strus and a foul on Horford. Three in the playoffs and games decided by 4 points or less. And Miami is 5-2 in the playoffs in clutch games. Games in the fourth quarter within 5 points.
Yeah, look, I think defensively, if you're the Celtics, Reggie, you know Jimmy Butler's capable of beating you. You've got to make somebody else do it at this point.
Well, they did. They took out Grant Williams. Jimmy Butler was over there shaking his head.
But I'm not sure anybody out here can stop Jimmy Butler one-on-one.
Here comes back into the zone for the Heat.
It's a tie try for Brown. No, missing the triple. Rebound Adebayo. Approaching two to play.
So now you've got Tatum more length. The switch out here with Brogdon on Jimmy Butler. This is when I'd run a double at him now.
Absolutely.
Butler with it over Brogdon. Rebound by Brown. He'll penetrate by Vincent. Ball deflected. Bodies down on top Horford. Plenty of time on the clock. Splitting the defense. Tatum inside. Crouching whistle. Foul. Offensive foul. Tatum.
And again,
they take care of all those areas, Reggie.
Boston led it 96-87 with 6.5 to go.
They need a stop in the worst way right now.
Butler driving on Brogdon, doubled by Smart. Ball jarred free, saved Miami. Vincent three, no! Offensive rebound Adebayo. Strus will drive and slow it with Smart meeting him defensively. Something's wrong here with the clock, I believe. They're going to reset.
24.
Yep. 16-4 run Miami. Butler and Brogdon. Shot clock at three. Butler will chisel. And missing. Adebayo!
That's the worst foul right now for Miami.
To score three with the clock stopped.
Bam, one assist away from a triple-double here.
Tatum at the line, 7 of 8. 30 points, 13 rebounds, 8 assists. Big numbers across the board.
See the timeout situation. Miami has two of them. You wonder if Coach Folster will take one here to advance the basketball. That was the worst foul you could possibly want if you are a Heat fan. Right now, Boston reeling. You get a chance now with three free throws with your best player at the line and a chance to set your defense. Gotta get the ball in.
Rob Williams is in. In a two-point Miami lead. Kayla Martin. It's Gabe Vincent. Setting up, two-point shot, good!
Not Jimmy Butler, not Bam Adebayo, but Gabe Vincent.
It's off to Tatum. Butler is on him. Ball knocked away. He turned it over a couple times in game one. That is off of Miami. Shot clock at 20. Here comes Tatum. He lost it again. It's picked up, vacuumed in. Smart's got it. He slips. He finds Tatum, who readjusts inside with a whistle and a foul.
With a chance to cut it to two.
And 9 of 10 from the stripe, and he hits one right there. Reggie's got 33 on the evening.
But again, he had 29 coming into the fourth. No field goals again for Jason Tatum here in the fourth. All his points are coming from the free throw line.
But I will say this. A difference in philosophy here. The Heat have run doubles at Jason Tatum the entire fourth quarter.
It's a Strus inbound. It's picked up by Vincent. Spins by Brogdon. Fouled on the drive. 19.3 left.
He almost tripped over the official doing it.
When was the last time you've seen that called, though, Reggie? It's the big free throw right here.
Look at this. I mean, he's doing the electric slide right there.
Well, Gabe Vincent hit the big jumper. Now he's got a chance to put him up four again with two free throws.
He got it. 109-105, 19 seconds to go. Well,
Celtics saving that timeout. They want a three right here.
Smart, Tatum long three. It's off, down goes Smart. Rebound, Strus. Out to Vincent, and a foul on Boston.
4 points or less, haven't been able to win ball games.
Derek White picked up his first foul for the Celtics. They got Strus at the line.
That look says it all right there.
It's tough to come back from 2-0 down when you're going on the road, but, well, this is interesting. They're not going to even take a timeout here. They've got one timeout left. I mean, they're just going to let the game go.
Six-point game. This is Brown. Doubled on the three try. No, Miami wins it. Miami has won and gone up two games to none. Who would have believed this? The eighth seed on the road.
Adebayo brings it up. Butler on the wing over Holiday. Wow. Got it!
And here we
Butler.
Go. Here we go. Check your watch, it's Jimmy time. And he is
talking. Mastery it yet again.
And he is talking right to Drew Holiday, letting him know about it.
Oh, Adetokounmpo stems the tide for the moment. Bucket and the foul. And a huge one from Milwaukee.
And the world's losing.
What a rebound. Chases down the miss. Huge. Matthews. Wouldn't go. Miami can tie and take the lead. Under 2 minutes to play. Bucks facing elimination. Adebayo ties it up at 113.
What a tough shot by Bam.
Bam Adebayo has 16.
If I'm Miami, I'm setting the double. I'm not letting Middleton play against Gabe Vincent.
Here it comes. They've got a hand on it.
There's the double team.
Throws it away. Strus. Lopez on the floor. Butler with a hand on it. Everybody in there.
What a game that is transpiring right in front of our eyes.
Lopez got a hand on it. It goes out of bounds. And they say it's tipped and back to the Bucks. Wow, some nervous moments here in Milwaukee.
We see Lopez. Yeah, that definitely went off Bam. It might be time for the big action. The screen and roll with Giannis and Lopez. Miami's had a really hard time guarding that. And that's exactly what they're going to run.
Giannis has 33. Elbow jumper up, no good. Who else? But Jimmy Butler comes away with it. Under a minute to play.
You know Jimmy Butler's going to get the ball. Miami wants him to bring this game home. If you're the Milwaukee Bucks, you got one job. Do not let Jimmy get a shot.
Screen from Adebayo. Screams Butler. And for once, he cannot connect.
And that was probably one of his best looks he's gotten off order.
The Bucks on the brink. Tied up. It's Giannis. Out to Lopez. Middleton has it. Likes that matchup. Back to Middleton. Six in the shot clock. Love comes out, and that is his sixth foul. Four on the night. He's got 28. Big ones.
And he's been in these moments before.
Shot 90% in the regular season.
Much as we talk about Giannis and what he did in that championship run, let's not forget how strong Middleton played as well in the playoffs that year. He's tapping back into that tonight.
They really missed him last spring. Didn't play the first 20 games of this season after summer wrist surgery. He is healthy now, and he is delivering late.
And I'm involved with Lopez because Lopez is in drop coverage, and I know Jimmy will get a good shot. They're going with the pick and roll option.
Bam. Like that Holiday. Butler couldn't make it. Middleton got a timeout. Bucks need the win to extend their series and their season. Holiday ran away. Eventually, Strews caught up with him. And they only went off about 2.3 on the clock. The
season. And with 14 seconds left,
Holiday delivers. Here comes Vincent.
What you can't do is foul.
Over Matthews and good.
Wow.
Gabe Vincent.
Big shot from Gabe.
He's got 22. That's a postseason career high.
Oh, no, they turned it over.
Oh, they turned it over. Lowry had it, and he lost it.
Who's the, I think the foul's on Middleton.
They called
the
foul
on Lowry.
I think that's the
way it's going to be. After review, the defender gets his hand on the ball and deflects it away. This is a legal defensive play by Kyle Lowry. The challenge is successful. The contact by Middleton is ruled marginal and incidental. At the time of the whistle, there was no possession. Therefore, we will jump it up center circle, any two.
Oh, my God. Pippo has it, and he lost it into the seats, saved it to Drew Holiday.
You okay, boss?
I'm okay, though.
I have used it between Middleton and me. And a miss there.
A missed free throw by Holiday.
2 seconds to go. 2.1 left. Boy, they're playing with fire here. He still have a timeout. They will be able to advance. Middleton gets one of two. 2-point game. He's got over the top to Butler. Up and in! Jimmy Butler! Ties the game with a half second to go.
What a play call.
Milwaukee had a timeout and didn't use it.
Why would you not call a timeout and advance the ball? You kind of know what this is going to be. Get the ball to Jimmy and get out the way time.
Vincent past Matthews. Bam Adebayo. Johnny on the spot.
What an offensive rebound by Bam. Lopez had to give help. And Bam was right there to finish.
It's the Heat by five. Antetokounmpo going hard, up no good. And Bam back just to the free throw line. And Adebayo just fouled out.
Bam just fouled out.
There he is, 10 of 21.
And a tough night for him at the free throw line. It's been a struggle. Sometimes when you have one of those nights, it can become a mental thing.
This is the most free throw attempts Antetokounmpo has ever made in a postseason game.
He missed that one short.
10 of 23, nearly got the offensive board. And it ricochets to Strews. Under 2 minutes to go. Miami trying to become the sixth, eighth seed ever to beat a number one. It's Butler. All the way to the rim and wiped away by Lopez.
What a block by Lopez.
But out of bounds and back to Miami with five on the shot clock. He couldn't keep it in bounds. It's back to Miami. Inside Zeller with the flush.
And that was all off the Jimmy Butler cut. The Milwaukee Bucks overreacted to the cut. Two guys went with Jimmy. Zeller at the basket, nobody home. And it is quiet as I don't know what here in Milwaukee.
Matthews to Giannis. Nervous possession by the Bucks, and a foul by Vincent will put Middleton on the line. Middleton, 6 of 6 tonight, make it 7 of 7.
Are these 3 shots or 2 shots?
3 shots for Chris Middleton.
You see Middleton with the touch on the line. This is where, as a coach, you have to understand how the game is going in the flow. Middleton knocking down all of his free throws. Giannis struggling at the free throw line. When you come back down offensively, you have to go right back to Middleton. You can't afford for Giannis to go to the free throw line right now because Miami will gladly send him there.
Middleton cashes in on all threes, 9 of 9 on the night. But Miami leads it by 4. Can they finish the job?
You gotta send somebody. You can't let Jimmy play one-on-one. And you definitely can't run a drop coverage right here. Send help. Great
stealing. Giannis has it in the open floor. Matthews back to Holiday. Cross-court Middleton. Inside Giannis. Vincent on him. Up and in. Huge bucket from the Greek Freak. And it's a 2-point game. Caleb Martin brings it up for Miami, up by 2. Under a minute to play here in overtime. What a game 5.
And why isn't Jimmy getting the rock?
Martin massages it.
And Giannis
and fouled by Giannis.
Wow. Oh my goodness.
3 free throws for Max Strus in the regular season. Just 1 of 1 in this series coming in. First one is up and through. Possession game now, and Strus has a chance for one more. Grayson Allen, Pat Connaughton, both in for the Bucks, both 3-point shooters. David Highsmith comes in for defensive purposes for Miami. And Strus still waiting for his 3rd free throw. One rattles out. Here comes Middleton with some pace. Connaughton back to him. Contested three, that's well off, but Antetokounmpo is there for the putback.
It's a 2-point game. You don't have to foul, but you have to get a stop.
Giannis has 36.
If you're the Milwaukee Bucks, you got to dig deep right here. Jimmy's going to set the screen.
Butler calls out now. They switch. Holiday defends Vincent. In and out. Giannis has it.
Get it to Middleton.
2-point game. Butler steps in front. Middleton. Allen has it. Down the lane. He ran out of time. The Bucks don't get off his shot. Oh, and my. The Miami Heat become the 6th in NBA history to win as an 8th seed in the first round.
Not Iguodala this time. Into the lane. Blocked by Clay. LeBron fade away. Clay Thompson rebound. What a sequence for Clay Thompson.
He's had a couple blocks here in this quarter.
3 players jump at Curry. Iguodala misfiring. David Lee, look what I found. Great work on the glass.
What happens with an air ball, Bob?
Air ball goes to the offense. Chapter 3, Book of Barnett. Single possession ball game.
makes its presence felt, exhorting the Warrior defense. Deflected. Lee leading the break. David calls timeout.
It stops at the defensive end. It gives them an opportunity to push it and run a little bit and strike before the defense gets set for Miami.
Hey, Thompson, deep two, got it. A little weaving between Iguodala and David Lee, and it's an 8-0 Warrior run. And they'll be standing here the rest of the way. Shot clock at 4. They find Beasley. Better look, LeBron. 3 on the way. Rimming out. An offensive rebound.
Great closeout. Thompson.
Chalmers hits a 3.
Thompson did his job on Ray Allen. But he can't guard two people.
Monster offensive rebound for the Heat on that scattered miss. David Lee in on Beasley, and he's fouled.
Once again, Chris Bosch comes way out on Steph Curry. He's made one shot on him tonight. Did the right thing there and found David Lee right down the gut.
I'm impressed with the Warrior recognition. They're finding whoever Beasley is guarding.
Yeah.
And going right to that matchup. Greg Pop and Gary St. Jean are here at Oracle for Warrior Post Game Live, brought to you by Honda. And what a game to talk about. David Lee, 20-11 tonight, and a two-point game. Chalmers off the hands of Bosch, bats it back out. Beasley will take the big shot. Curry the rebound. Chance to tie or take the lead. Everyone guarding Steph.
Yeah, watch the deflections.
David Lee wheels in to the line again. And who did he go at?
Lee, they let him go and they stay two men on Steph.
David missing the free throw. Warriors are 19 of 24 from the line. And moving up the charts in terms of free throw percentage, much more like a year ago when they were top five. David Lee splitting a pair. 2 minutes of crunch time. And then the All-Star break.
At times it's been Thompson. Last possession, it is Thompson on LeBron. This time Iguodala.
LeBron wants it back. David Lee steal! Chance to take the lead. Curry wheeling, flipping, blocked by Bosch.
It appeared he could have kept that ball in play instead of knocking it out of bounds and giving the Warriors possession.
16 to shoot. And Battier will check in. And they're taking Beasley out of the game.
Yep, they're bringing in a defender. Glad to see Barnes back in here.
Steph and David, two-man game. Iguodala will save the turnover. Shot clock at 5. On a good defender in Battier. Tough turn, fade. Hit it!
I think when he takes a difficult shot, there's no thought process. He just wants to get it off. When he has an easy one and they give it to him, then he starts to aim it.
Up one. LeBron sizing up Klay Thompson. Shot clock at 5. At 3. Rises for 3. Buries it. The greatest player in the game today with 32. Curry. Pump fake. Jumper. Good. We're tied at 107.
Had the ball on the string. and he strung out Chalmers.
It's Iguodala this time.
Well, the clock favors Miami if they take advantage.
LeBron's not giving it up.
They should have gotten a shot right about now.
Shot clock at 5. LeBron driving and foul. Step back. LeBron James hits the first free throw. He's 4 of 6 from the line. Remember, 75% free thrower. It's not necessarily automatic when he goes to the line.
I just saw him miss two earlier tonight.
And misfires there.
Now here's the dilemma. Well, it didn't matter because they used a little time on the miss. You cannot afford a careless pass here.
Lee Iguodala, Harrison Barnes, Klay Thompson, Steph Curry. 19,596 have been standing the whole fourth quarter.
See, Curry went on his own.
Steph, runner, good! Foul!
He didn't want to take a chance on that screen and get a double team and give up the ball. This young man likes to take the closer. Now, here's the deal. He's going to make the free throw. Miami has plenty of time.
Curry with 28 points, 7 assists, 5 rebounds, and those 28 points on only 14 shots. He went before the double team could get to him.
Went away from the screen that was getting set up.
Free throw good. Miami not using a timeout.
They're saving it. Interesting.
No shot clock. You need one stop. Do you send multiple players at LeBron? Down to 5. Down to 3.
Make somebody else beat you.
A 3 on the way. He got it!
Make somebody else beat you. Take the ball out of his hands.
The game is over.
Yes, it is.
You cannot secure an attempt to shot inside of 0.3 seconds by rule. And Harrison Barnes also could get a running start. So the lob, and that will do it. So LeBron James, the 3-pointer at the end, a scintillating game.
Offense, deservingly so. Jason Tatum and the Celtics leading by 6. Butler downhill. Dragic back to Butler. Hero wide open. Butter. And the lead is down to 3. 3:12 to go.
Excellent patience. Ball moved appropriately.
Miami going to try and dig in here defensively. Butler on Tatum. Big time matchup. Tice with the short jumper. Got it.
Good delivery by Jason Tatum.
His playmaking skills on display there. Lead back up to 5. Butler got the switch. Walker on him. Dragic for 3. High arcing 3. Bam battling, and that's going to be a foul on the ground.
10 points and 5 rebounds, 8 assists.
They run a lot of their offense through him. Knocks down the first free throw. The Heat knew from the very first time they worked him out in pre-draft workouts that he was their guy. Great Pat Riley loves those guys from Kentucky. His alma mater. The lead is down to 3. Tatum with 27 points. Butler switching back down to him. Deep 3 and missed everything. Rushed that one a little bit. Spoelstra makes the call from the sidelines.
He saw the window open for it because Hero, it looked like Hero was going to switch. And in attempting to get Butler back on him, I think he thought the window was tighter than it was.
Great tonight defense by Marcus Smart. He is all over Jimmy Butler. Butler finally able to make a catch. Working against Walker. Hero picked up his dribble. Jimmy launching a three. Butler front rimmed it. And rebounded by Tatum. Under 2 minutes to go. Tatum screens for Walker. Walker over to Tatum. A little shaky on this possession. Down to five. Butler staying in front of Tatum, forcing him to make a tough shot. Rebounded by Jaylen Brown, and another possession for the Celtics. Great hustle by Jaylen Brown.
Just elite athleticism and timing to get between those white jerseys.
Walker with a quick sit dribble, working on Crowder. Got it! Kemba! Right at the end of the shot clock. Hero for three. Yes!
This guy.
Right back at him, and the lead is down to two with a 102 to go.
Golly, this young man just unfazed.
See if he can stay in front of Kemba Walker. Crowder switches on to Walker. Kemba going through the legs, little machine gun dribble here. Gonna go to work here. Into the paint. Great stop by Walker, Crowder. And it'll come back the other way on the shot clock violation. To go, Miami down by two.
Kemba checking Crowder.
Now they get a switch. Jimmy Butler with a height advantage. Takes it right into the bucket. Bam at the elbow. Dragic on the drive. Butler three on the way. Got it, Jimmy. Buckets. Splashdown. And the Heat take a 1 point lead. Night and a big stop on him by Jake Crowder. And that's going to be a whistle and a foul on Derrick Jones Jr., it looks like, who ran right over and through Marcus Smart. So the ball had not been inbounded. That's going to be a free throw and possession for Boston.
Well, it's right in the middle of the paint. And Kemba really kind of by his path runs him right into Marcus.
Yeah. Wouldn't you know that Marcus Smart would be right in the middle of it. Tatum at the free throw line with an attempt to tie the game. And Boston keeps the ball.
Yeah, huge, Mark, because you don't have to obviously give the Heat a look.
He's on Walker. Now backs off. Boston going to run it right down. We've got Walker and Tatum out top. Tatum on Jones. This is it. The defining moment for the win. Tatum. And we'll go to another 5 minutes of play. Back to Tatum, guarded by Adebayo. Sidestep three, rebounded by Hero. Quick hit ahead, bam, out front, and slams it in.
What a play by Tyler Hero. A little peek ahead as he's getting possession of the basketball. The perfect pass below the hand of the defender. Beautiful.
The Heat have really dug in defensively, and now on a 7-0 run. Grant Williams setting the screen for Walker. Hesitation move back to Williams. Wide open three. Brown with a spectacular airborne tip. Jaylen Brown makes it a 1 point Miami lead. Jaylen Brown quietly with 17 points and 5 rebounds.
Boy, the amount of minutes by some of the players on the floor tonight, plenty of them north of 40 minutes.
Miami has had 6 days off. Jimmy Butler with a blocking foul going to go against Kemba Walker, who's left incredulous. And the Nuggets, the winner taking on the Lakers in the Western Conference Finals. Marcus Smart switches back on to Butler. Little ISO on the wing. Butler. Hero for three. And Tatum with the rebound. Boy, that halfway down and out. Adebayo tasked with guarding Tatum. Tough shot. And Miami comes out of the pack with a rebound. Bam Adebayo moving his feet well.
Nice to have your center be able to make that stop.
The reason why he made all defense this year. Butler downhill, off glass, no good. And Boston gets the stop. 39 seconds to go. Dragic on Walker. Good defense, whistle. And Mark Davis calls a foul.
Signals
Miami
trip.
Had one to give.
Yes.
The fifth on Dragic. Marcus Smart. Pocket pass never made it. And that's going to be a kick ball. Tough cover for Hero here against Kemba Walker. The step back. He's done it so many times and does it again. Butter. Kemba Walker giving Boston the lead. Jumps to Butler. Guarded by Tatum. Dragic clears it out. Butler downhill on Tatum. Into traffic. Got it! And one! Clutch time, Dade County. Jimmy Butler delivering. The lead is two. And Brad Stevens calls timeout. Meanwhile, Tatum out front. Clock at seven. Working against Butler. Got downhill. Couldn't punch it. Bam says get it out of here. Out of bio. Sky high with the block and rejection. Bam out of bio with a great stat line tonight. Misses the free throw, but 17 points, 6 rebounds, 9 assists, and a key block.
No timeouts here for Boston.
Yeah, no timeouts, and it's still just a one possession game because he missed that free throw.
Make or miss, this is a one possession game, but you've got to get it to the 3-point line in 2.5 if he makes it.
Knocks down the second. The lead is three. Boston needs a three. Do they foul or not? We'll see if they do it on the catch. Not. Tatum makes the catch. Got it off in time. Online, but no good. And the Heat win game one in overtime.
Biggest game of his life. Butler, seven to shoot. Smart up on him. Lowry connects. Kyle Lowry with the answer. His fourth three-pointer.
That is a tough, tough shot by Kyle Lowry.
There was, and great defense by the Celtics.
16 points plus 10 assists for Lowry. What a bounce-back game for the All-Star. Tatum drives on Strus, kicks it out. Smart, three-pointer, short. Strus hauls in the rebound, and Lowry is shaken up.
That's a great rebound in traffic. With as small as Miami is,
Kyle Lowry has been a shell of himself the previous two games here in the elimination game. Has been so tough. Adebayo drives on Horford, shut off. 5 on the 24. Lowry drives down the lane, running layup shot, no good, but a foul. And it's been out quite often as Lowry knocks down the free throw. It now gives them back a 1-point lead with 3:36 remaining. 17 points, 10 assists. He didn't have a point or an assist playing 25 minutes in game five. Now he puts the Heat up two. Smart. And they're starting to call it tight. Lowry picks up his fifth personal foul.
Guys get on the side of people, and that leads to the start of the drive and the hand checks and the grabs.
Smart's numbers. He's played 37 minutes. Hits a pair. Well, Eric Spoelstra said, go enjoy the challenge and competition of game six. We have had that here tonight. All tied at 99 with 3:20 to play.
Again, running down, playing against the clock.
Butler drives. Lost it out of bounds, comes up hobbling. It's still Heat ball with seven to shoot. Seven on the 24. Strus looks to get free. Backed out of bio. Drives into the paint, stops, jump shot. Misses it. Horford comes in and grabs the rebound.
We talked about Strus rebounding in traffic. What a rebound by Al Horford. Going and getting it. want to get Jason Tatum the basketball.
Smart holding at 4 on the 24. He's dribbled the most of the possession. Smart, three-pointer, missed it. Lowry the rebound.
This is where you got to run, but again, no communication.
And White with the steal, Jeff. Another big play from Derek White.
And I'm bringing Kruse in the action. Get Jason Tatum the matchup he wants and get out of his way.
Tatum to Brown. Brown, three-pointer. And a foul. Let's see, do they call it on the floor? Or motion. And Brown, who's been up and down from the free throw line, but was 7 for 7 here tonight before that miss.
Without Kyle Lowry in the game, who will be the primary ball handler for the Heat?
Gotta be Jimmy Butler.
Brown misses both. 2:15 remaining. Oladipo is back in, but Butler brings it up the floor. Butler drives, goes inside. It's good, and the foul. Jimmy Butler once again. And the Heat go up 2 with a free throw coming up. 41 in game one. He's got 43 tonight. And it's a three-point lead. Both teams still with a couple of timeouts remaining. Both teams in the penalty. White looking. Struce all over Tatum. Tatum on the drive, spins. Tucker takes it away. PJ Tucker with the steal. And a foul called by on Derek White. And the Celtics upset. 17 for 17. And Tucker drills that one, trying to keep his dream alive of back-to-back championships. Won a title with the Bucks last year.
And Mike, you look back at that foul. You could say it's marginal contact. You could also say, what is Derek White doing, even giving the referee a chance to make that call?
2 clutch free throws there from Tucker after Jaylen Brown missed the pair. And the lead back up to 5 for Miami.
Good assumption, the mentality. There's plenty of time left in this ballgame. Get a quality trip on the offensive end.
Tatum drives, kicks it out. Horford, an open three. In and out. Rebound, Tucker. With 1:25 remaining and a reach and foul. So more free throws from Tucker.
And we talked about the Heat.
Playoffs, but he hasn't missed a game. Been questionable for about half the games with a calf injury, an ankle injury, a knee injury. And let's see, was there contact? Oh, that looks like a clean swipe there from White.
It does.
That's the first miss at the line by the Heat.
And with Tucker getting it back, it almost plays into the Celtics' hands after the first miss that they didn't run the clock down.
Ime Udoka will use one of his 2 timeouts. And Brown out there for Boston. Brown comes up, Butler right with him. Tucker all over Tatum trying to deny. Brown drives, gets inside, looking. Kicks it outside to White. White, another 3. Ball tipped by Horford, still alive. Tatum has it. Tatum now the drive. The floater is good. 4-point game with 108 remaining.
You don't have to foul. Get back and defend. And if you're the Heat, eat clock and execute.
28 for Tatum.
And I want the ball in Butler's hands, but the lack of defensive rebounding by Miami.
Victor Oladipo here in the final minute of game 6 on the floor with Lowry fouled out. Butler against White, 4 on the 24. Butler deflected out of bounds. Still Miami ball, 2.2 to shoot.
Yeah, you got to pay attention to Struce. His ability to catch and shoot in traffic. And he's the guy taking it out of bounds, but there's plenty of time where he's live. A little fake handoff maybe from Butler.
Finds Butler. Butler turns, fires. It's good as the shot clock expires. Jimmy Butler, and it's a 6-point lead. It's a 2-pointer, and Butler now has 45.
We talked about the action. Jimmy Butler fake handoff and then elevates. That's a huge shot.
Man,
he's been special.
And if you're out of bio, you want to shadow Tatum up the court to take time off in the early attack.
6-point lead. Tatum pushing. Splits the defense. And a reach in and a foul.
Well, they might want to challenge that.
Tatum perfect on that one. All right, with this time remaining, as you see Tatum and Brown here in this fourth quarter, the turnovers have hurt them before earlier in this series. What's the strategy in terms of fouling for the Boston Celtics?
To me, it's still plenty of time. I'd look to get a defensive stop right now. There's plenty of time left in this ball game, and it's a 4-point game.
Full court pressure. Butler has it. Butler still in the backcourt, gets it across the timeline. Now drives, gets into the lane, kicks it out to Vincent. Vincent off the bounce. Vincent underneath. Adebayo has it. Taking time off the clock. 8 to shoot. Butler on a drive. Butler keeps his dribble alive, pulls up, jump shot. Shot won't go. Horford the rebound. 17 seconds remaining. Celtics down 4. Now to Brown. Brown drives, goes in, misses the jam. And a whistle. The officials, now there is the signal, a blocking call on Oladipo.
After review, the defender was not in the restricted area and legal prior to the upward motion of the shooter. The ruling on the floor has been overturned to an offensive foul.
For the officials, trying to get a 5-second count close. Butler catches it, and he's fouled by Tatum with 10. Again, the fourth time in these playoffs, he's hit the 40-point mark. Now a 5-point lead. The Heat had that great victory here at TD Garden in Game 3. And on the verge of this victory here in Game 6. Butler brilliance tonight to keep the Heat alive.
And no 3.
Close to a 5. Horford gets it. Al Horford a 3-pointer. Back of the rim won't go. And a loose ball foul is going to go against the Celtics.
3. And Kyle Lowry made that wing jump shot, that tough 3 to tie it up.
Played with that desperation as Vincent capping things off. 8 seconds remaining. Lead up to 8. White, who was terrific tonight, misses that one, and that'll do it. Game 7 Eastern Conference Finals Sunday in Miami. Bosh. Yeah, nearly had that. As James says, clear it out. 5 to shoot. It's been the LeBron James show in the second half. Lobs it up to Anderson. Anderson up and under, won't go. Rebound tipped and taken by Leonard. And they call a 24-second violation.
And coach, that's why I disagree. I don't think it's a tough call. If you're talking about Wade, Bosh, Allen on the floor with James, the help's got to come from Birdman. You've got to force him to beat you. And that time, throws the pass on point, wasn't able to finish.
Duncan finds Ginobili. Green, cross-court Diaw. On the drive, back up top to Green. Green spinning, lefty, wild layup, won't go, and Anderson the rebound. And Wade and Duncan shaking up on that play. Wade comes up hobbling, he got hit in the head.
And you don't want to screen if you're James. Matter of fact, you want everybody out of your way and take advantage of the smaller Tony Parker.
James drives, pulls up, short jumper, misses. Diaw the rebound. His 9th board. Still tied with 3.5 to play.
And again, size on Tony Parker.
Ginobili back to Diaw. Ginobili a long 3. Rebound Wade.
This is terrific Miami defense right now, though. We're seeing him cover the initial pick and roll and X out of the help and get to the 3-point line.
3 minutes remaining. Game 2 hanging in the balance. 5 to shoot. James finds Allen to Anderson. Reverse layup. Great ball movement, and Miami back up 2.
Great pass by Ray Allen. That's the play we saw a steady diet of in the Eastern Conference Finals, where he's coming off that weak side double down, pin down, and made the play for Birdman.
Again, more switching.
Ginobili on the drive, back out to Parker. Parker for three. It's good. Timeout Miami. Spurs up by one.
And the Spurs right now with a one-point lead.
An interesting thing, Coach. They continue to keep Boris Diaw as the primary defender on James and Leonard on Wade.
And so Leonard's got to be thinking help.
Bosch from the corner of three. Leonard this time gets the rebound. Keeps it away from Wade. Parker looking. Wade's now on Duncan on the switch. Parker's got James on him. Four to shoot. Parker in the paint. Fakes. Strip. Knocked out of bounds. And it's still, they say, San Antonio ball, but there's 1:43 remaining, so it's under 2 minutes. They can look at it. Execute again. You have plenty of time to catch, turn, and shoot on 8/10 of a second. Can't put it on the floor. Ginobili catches, fires a three. And away the rebound. Pretty good look considering.
And now Miami offensively with no Birdman on the floor. They've got live options.
Chalmers back in. Leonard playing with five fouls guarding James. Spurs do have a foul to give. James kicks it out corner to Bosch, an open three. It's good. Chris Bosch from downtown, and the Heat go up two.
Exactly what I was talking about. You take Birdman out the ball game, now there's a price to pay. Great decision by James.
And Tony Parker guarding the picker did a very poor job.
Ginobili got hit in the face. Continues pass off of Duncan's fingertips. Miami ball. He tried to jam it in there. Ginobili saying, I got hit in the face. It's only their second turnover of the second half.
And if you're Miami, stay with the same thing. It's a 1-3 pick and roll with Chalmers setting the screen on LeBron James, forcing Parker in the action.
James drives down a lane, lefty layup. He got tripped up. And James will go to the free throw line with 47.7 remaining and his team up by two from game one in the leg cramps. James now with 35 points.
And going forward, Kawhi Leonard, for them to win the series, is going to have to play better. He was outstanding last year in the finals.
This is that dunk in the rebound. Three-point game. San Antonio still has multiple timeouts.
And they want to get a two-for-one opportunity here.
Diaw with Wade on him. Allen right up on Ginobili. Ginobili behind the back, steps back, a two-pointer. Won't go. Rebound stripped. Diaw tried to get it. Miami ball. 28.3 left, so 4.3 difference. How does San Antonio play this, Jeff?
Well, I'm going to play it out at 4.3 and not foul, clearly off Diaw. But I might trap, though, too, to try to get Miami to take an earlier shot.
They no longer have a foul to give. Bosch puts it on the floor. Bounce passed away. Banks it in. And a five-point lead for Miami with 9.4 remaining. Chris Bosch with some big plays down the stretch. A three-pointer, and here with the assist. Neither team with a foul to give. Ginobili gets it. Diaw fakes, wasting too much time. Diaw's shot won't go. Diaw gets the rebound back out to Ginobili for three. That's good at the buzzer, but Miami has won and have tied the NBA Finals at one game apiece. A huge bounce back victory for the Heat. They do it again. They follow a playoff loss with a superb victory. Wade back in the game. Walker bumps him. Richardson fakes, drives. Left-handed, shot won't go. Whiteside on the follow, and a foul. So Whiteside and Wade return, and Whiteside a chance for a three-point play. Michael Jordan has been absolute in misery watching this.
This is agony for Jordan. Again, every time Jefferson has to come over
to try to challenge a shot. Whiteside just moves Kaminsky and is able to get the putback basket.
Under four to play. Kemba Walker had 34 in the last home game in game four. He's got 30 points here in game six. Wade picks him up on the switch. Walker again uses Jefferson screen, three-pointer. Jefferson tips it out in a new 24. Walker puts his head down, throws it back out, stolen by Wade. And Wade is fouled by Courtney Lee.
Serious problem trying to contain this Miami Heat offense. Even on missed shots, there's open guys. Pick and rolls, isolations, they're making plays.
Leon Wade. Wade had the big first half, but only 2 points in the second half. Shot clock down to six. Wade finds Dang. Dang fakes back up to Wade. A rare three. It's good! Dwayne Wade from downtown! It's only the second three-pointer he's taken in the series and his first make. He hasn't hit a three since December. Walker, count it, and a foul! Kemba Walker answers back. 5 for 5 from the line. Whiteside fouls out in 27 minutes. Richardson knocked it out of bounds. Hornets get it back.
I don't know if you agree, Coach, but if I'm Miami, Kemba Walker gets rid of the basketball, you have no help responsibility, and I'm in all-out denial. Somebody else has got to make a play.
Because without Lynn on the floor, they don't really have anybody else to create a play off the dribble.
Walker drives, blocked by Dang, and knocked off Joe Johnson's leg. He did not get possession, so the shot clock didn't reset. Still at 18.
And Mike, we've talked about Steve Clifford, but has there ever been a better, more humble coach in this league than Eric Spoelstra for all he's accomplished?
He's done a great job.
Unbelievable. Year after year.
Two championships in the LeBron James era. Trying to force a game seven here tonight. Walker for three. Bang! Wade on the drive. The floater too strong. Walker rips down the rebound. They're going to check that last shot to make sure it's a three. Puts his head down. Inside to Jefferson. Offensive foul. Luol Deng draws another charge. He's drawn two here on the fourth. Walker has 12 of his 35 here on the fourth. Miami Heat in their season on the line right now, trying to hang on. They couldn't do it in game five. Johnson away. Wade trying to draw the foul, gets it to Dragic. Dragic inside, his jumper won't go. Wade tips it, picked up by Lee, ahead to Walker. But the Heat are back, and Walker slows down for a second. Now drives, layup, he banks it in. Points. The last 12 for Charlotte. Timeout Miami. Keep him in front of you. Boy, is he showing that time and time again here tonight. Minute and a half remaining. Wade pulls back again. Wade finds Dang. Dang for three. Air ball, Dragic saves it. Johnson, does he get it off in time? Doesn't matter. Another shot that doesn't hit the rim and a 24-second violation.
And that's championship effort by Kemba Walker.
Of course, he, like everybody else, has struggled to stop Kemba Walker, who has the last 12 points for Charlotte. Walker pulls back, jump shot. Haslam pulls down the rebound.
He had a great look, though.
Under a minute remaining. Will there be a game seven? Wade, another three. It's good. Dwayne Wade from downtown.
had not hit a three-pointer since December and knocks down two here in the fourth quarter.
Walker, Haslam picks it up. Walker again drives inside to Jefferson. Beautiful setup from Kemba Walker.
Good offense. A lot of teams in that situation fall in love with needing the three-pointer. Oh, you need to score the basket.
Back to three.
Wade wants Kemba Walker to switch on him.
Wade leans in, falling away, puts it in! Dwayne Wade does it again! And Charlotte has to call timeout. What a clutch performance from Dwayne Wade. Walker fakes the three, drives, gets to the rim, blocked from behind! Dwayne Wade with the block as well! Wade throws it back. And Richardson's shaken up. Wade throws it ahead. Johnson has it. They have to foul and finally do with 5.4 remaining. He got away with a foul.
Wade. But I tell you what, purple shirt man got to sit down. And somebody's got to control him. I think Dwayne Wade is handling it fine. But you don't have the right to be disrespectful on the sideline.
Good call, Mark. Joe Johnson, meanwhile, hits the two free throws. And Miami comes into Charlotte and forces a game seven. Unbelievable finish for Dwayne Wade. A vintage performance. Lowry with six to shoot. Caldwell Pope chasing with five fouls. Inside, Adebayo, and a foul. What a pass and finish. The lead is 10 and a chance for a three-point play.
Pick and roll action. Bam does a great job of setting the screen and rolling. Finishes at the rim with the contact.
Just like Kevin Love in the starting lineup, Kyle Lowry and Robinson off the bench have been terrific.
A former champion, of course, with the Toronto Raptors. And this equals Miami's largest lead, under five to play here in the fourth. An 11-point advantage. A stunning turnaround. Heat on the road. Murray drives, gets inside, shot blocked by Adebayo. Michael Malone thought it was on the way down. It was close. But the Heat with another big play here in the fourth. Crowd just saw the replay. Butler the drive. Robinson fakes. 5 on the 24. Back to Robinson. Inside Adebayo. Shot clock at 2. And he throws it away. Good defense from Denver. Murray, oh, nice fake. Drive back to Jokic, lays it up and in. And a quick timeout call by Eric Spoelstra. Oh, the Miami Heat. Well, a fantastic fourth quarter. Jamal Murray, though, trying to keep Denver's hopes alive. Another big performance from Nikola Jokic. Here's the unpredictable. Seven times the lower seed has won a series in these playoffs. Most in 39 years. The Heat have done it three times. Trying to make it four here in the finals and trying to even up the finals at one apiece. Butler, elbow jumper short, right back to him. Out to Martin. Martin, three-pointer, puts it in. Caleb Martin from downtown. Murray using the screen, 4 on the 24. Cross-court Gordon. Gordon tries a three-pointer. Got it. Back to 9 with 3 minutes remaining.
But you see, even out of the zone, they blitzed Murray that time. Murray did a nice job finding Gordon.
Adebayo hands off the backboard all the way back to him. Up top to Lowry. Caleb Martin on the drive. Shot clock at 5. Lowry a three-pointer. And Gordon the rebound. Just over 2.5 remaining. Nuggets down 9. Murray a three-pointer. That's good. Jamal Murray from way downtown. It's back to 6. Jimmy Butler, jump shot. It's good. Big buckets from Jimmy Buckets here in the fourth.
and get the switch they want with Jamal Murray on Butler, get him in pick and roll action, and Jimmy Butler in rhythm, knocking down the mid-range.
Jokic back out. Murray fakes. Under two to play. Jokic calling for it. Now goes it out of bio, flips it up. Bank shot won't go. Can't get the rebound. Brown. His floater is good. 109-103.
Denver, you can't trade baskets. You got to find a way to get stops.
Butler taking his time. 21 points, 9 assists for Jimmy Butler. Murray on him. Butler up top. Robinson. Robinson a three-pointer. Adebayo trying to grab it. Goes out of bounds. Denver ball. Both teams with multiple timeouts.
And Gabe Vincent comes into the game for Duncan Robinson. Defensive purposes and another ball handler.
And both teams have been in the penalty for a long time.
Still, it's zone after zone after zone possession.
Murray up top. Caldwell Pope, three-pointer. That won't go. Jokic trying to grab the rebound. Back out to Murray. His three-pointer. Bang! Three-point game with just over a minute to play. Butler with six to shoot. Butler fakes, back to Adebayo, goes inside, and is fouled.
Jokic made an ill-advised gamble on a steal, which led to now Adebayo's.
And Adebayo knocks that first one down without a problem. Another 20-point game, but also 9 rebounds, 4 assists. 2 clutch free throws there from Bam Adebayo. 5-point Miami lead. Murray looking. Adebayo on him. To Jokic. Vincent all over him. Jokic layup shot. Rolled around and dropped through.
But good job defensively. You switch and you don't give up a three. Make them work for a tough two.
The Heat with a 3-point lead. 12-second difference between shot clock and game clock.
How do they defend Bam Adebayo rolling off the screen?
Butler with 8 to shoot. Butler outside Martin. Back up top Butler. Butler a three-pointer. Off the side of the rim. Brown the rebound. Should the Heat foul here?
I'm taking a foul. I'm not allowing them to get off a three.
Denver does have a timeout, but they're not using it. 4 seconds. Murray step back. Three-pointer. Won't go. Fight for the rebound. Martin. And it's over. The Miami Heat have tied the NBA Finals. What a comeback here on the road for the Heat. And it's one apiece.
Back in, I beg your pardon, after a quick break in this fourth. James all the way across court. There's Williams on Chalmers. And here's James coming in. Too far under the basket. Ray Allen for three. No. And it's Garnett who clears it away. Kept alive by Teletovich.
Great defensive job really by Garnett too. Didn't allow LeBron to elevate underneath and go for the finish. And then were able to secure that defensive backboard.
And he's been the go-to guy. He's been the most consistent scorer in this series. Teletovich open for a three. Missed badly.
It's tough. Remember, Teletovich really has not been involved in the rotation. Oh, my goodness.
And here's LeBron for three. Got it. Dwayne Wade got inside. Great crossover to do it. And LeBron James cans the three.
You remember what Jason Kidd said about late in games. One of the issues for them is that the ball always seems to find the wrong guy. That was an example there.
All right, Ernie, thanks. And the Nets and the Blazers trying to take a page out of the Wizards' book. Try to win on the road to keep this going. Paul Pierce out of the timeout. No, Garnett keeps it alive. Offensive board for Brooklyn. Under 2.5 to go in regulation. Key possession. Who takes the big shot for the Nets? And there is a foul. And a whistle from Joe Crawford. That'll be a foul on Ray Allen.
Yeah, one to give. Did the Heat, so no free throws here. Kevin Garnett just still a little bit left there. You can see he understands the importance of possessions right now.
Miami has hit three huge threes in their last three field goals made. Here's Pierce, and it's in and out. Bosch with the board. The Heat down five. LeBron James looking. Chalmers squeezes it in there to Dwayne Wade. Big bucket for Wade. That gives him 28 tonight.
In the last few possessions, Joe Johnson has not been involved here. Let's see if they try to get him an opportunity.
It's the first two-point basket of this quarter for Miami. The others have been threes. They trailed by nine, but now it's just a three-point deficit. Johnson and James blocks it. Ray Allen pulls it back. 1:23 to go in regulation. And James is fouled by Joe Johnson.
Joe Johnson's upset because he felt like the same thing happened to him on the possession previous. You see here, LaMondo, that's an unbelievable block to come up with that one. And also, remember, Joe Johnson hasn't really been out. So he's not a guy, he plays a lot of minutes, but I don't know that he's as accustomed to playing this many extended minutes as, say, LeBron James.
James now at 27, 12 in the fourth quarter. Nine rebounds for LeBron. Miami is plus 13 from the free throw line tonight. And make it plus 14 as James now 14 out of 15, 28 points.
Yeah, and the reason I make that point about Joe Johnson, he's playing a physical game. He's had to take 21 shots in this game. Doesn't average here anywhere near that. So extending a lot of energy here for the Nets.
Brooklyn by a point, under a minute to go. Sees it on the line for the Nets. Bounce it, gives it up. Livingston too deep for three. Joe J. No, and Chalmers the board. And now Miami, a chance to take the lead. And Wade calls the timeout.
Need to set up a 2-for-1 as well. So let's see how they play this.
Feels eerily similar for Brooklyn to game four. Brooklyn has not had a field goal in the last 4 minutes and change. Here's Chalmers, gives it up. Ray Allen will take the three for the lead. It's in! Ray Allen again! Miami on top! 32 to go in regulation. The memory on the road. 8 seconds separating the shot clock and the game clock. Williams and Livingston on the floor together. Livingston trying to turn the corner, down in the paint against Wade, and cannot get it. And the drought continues.
Quick foul. Still have a chance to maybe have a one possession game.
Joe Johnson hit a field goal with 4:49 left as Allen is fouled by Allen Anderson. Remember, those two came together in game three.
That was a situation right there, though, Ryan, where you could have probably got a trap right here. You see where Sean Livingston is? A hard trap there before you commit that foul. Just give yourself one count to get that steal before you give the foul and maybe even force the ball out of Ray Allen's hands, the one guy who you don't want on the line.
Ray Allen put game four away for Miami with clutch free throws. After Bosch had hit that three-pointer, Allen hits the three that gives Miami the lead. And Allen hits 3-for-3 from the line. That's a three-point Miami lead. Well, hard to figure. Brooklyn had an eight-point lead with 4:49 left when Joe Johnson made their last basket. He's got them both. Two possession game. 95-91. That's a 12-0 Miami run, and the kind of run.
Livingston to Garnett. Here's Paul Pierce. He'll take a three. In and out it goes. Offensive board, Livingston. Darren Williams whips it around. Joe Johnson for three. Yes! Joe Johnson, it's a big three. A one-point Miami lead. And out of bounds on Pierce, Miami ball. 0.4 left. Miami ball with a one-point lead. Here's LeBron James, and there is the foul, and James will head to the line where he is 14 out of 15 tonight.
He's been almost flawless there tonight, but none have been bigger than the two he's going to take. How about the Heat? 28 of 29 from the free throw line, and you see that's really what's been the difference in this second half. 8 three-pointers made by the two-time defending champs.
Brooklyn had a 7-point lead at the half. LeBron had 9 points. All those three-pointers missed, and James misses for just the second time tonight. And Brooklyn has a fighting chance here.
And you know what was interesting on that side out of bounds? The play was not even designed to get the ball in the hands of Ray Allen. It was, in essence, set up to get the ball to LeBron James and does not convert on the first opportunity.
One out of two for LeBron. And Jason Kidd takes his final 20-second timeout.
Pierce, but this has got to go to Joe Johnson or to Paul Pierce, and I think Joe Johnson's the guy.
And Johnson stepping in, and there's Pierce. And it is knocked away. And that is going to belong to Miami. So if that's all you have to go
on. Well, but
they're
going to continue. They still gave the ball to Brooklyn. So they're saying that he hit the ball as well as the hand of Paul Pierce. It's the right outcome. And
two ties at three puts Brooklyn ahead. And Bosch touched that one last, and that'll be Brooklyn ball. 6 tenths goes off the clock.
And the Heat want a review on the play. Doesn't look like they're going to get one here. No timeouts, though, for the Nets.
Livingston, the trigger man. Doesn't have a timeout. Got to get it in. Here's Joe Johnson. LeBron James on him. And trying to get it in. Cannot! And Miami has won it!
Ellington's fourth steal of the game. Ties the season high. He had four steals with Denver in a Heat win. Dion again! 5 points in the fourth quarter. 27 for the game. The Heat are up 10 with under 4 minutes left. A 17-4 run by Miami and a rebound for James Johnson. They're starting to believe in the Heat here at home tonight. Close to 20,000 fans, most of them on their feet. Six on the shot clock. And that's a kick on Green, which actually favors Miami. The shot clock was at 5. It gets reset to 14.
The Heat want to use some of the clock, but they don't want to stop attacking.
Eight on the shot clock for Waiters. Down the four. Waiters. Cross court for Johnson. The Heat do not get the shot off.
Yeah, good defense. You can see Waiters wanted the shot. Thompson switched on him. He couldn't get it off.
24-second violation. Turns into Miami's 15th turnover of the game. It's one of the differences in this game. Warriors have 16 points off Miami turnovers. Heat just 8 points off Warrior turnovers. Curry, a sense of where you are. He knew Whiteside was on his back. He induced Hassan. 19 points for the game. Stay tuned immediately following our game for tonight's Heat Live postgame show presented by Chrysler. Player interviews, locker room sound, highlights, analysis from Ron Rothstein and John Crotty. What's better than a coach and a point guard weighing in? All live from the Biscayne Bayside Studio. Heat Live presented by Chrysler coming up immediately following tonight's game. Well, Curry makes it an 8-point lead for Miami. And we get a foul in the backcourt with 3:10 left. Whiteside
with the free throws, though, and he's got two shots here.
By the way, Deion Waiters, Tony, 33 points against Milwaukee Saturday on 12 for 19 shooting. 27 tonight on 11 for 15. At 60 points in the last two games on 23 for 34 for Neon Deion Waiters. Whiteside missed them both. Smart foul by the Warriors. They're down eight. They have the ball. Green erased by Johnson. Taken down by Livingston, who lost the ball out of bounds. Last touch by a fired up James Johnson.
Yeah, it looked like
3:01 left. Klay Thompson for three.
Oh boy,
that's a huge three for Thompson. All four of his triples in the second half. He's got eight of his 22 points in the fourth quarter. Of the Splash Brothers have combined for 43. Miami's lead is five. 2:43 left. Dragic against the taller Durant. Ellington for three. What a rough night for Wayne Ellington. He's 3 for 12.
You see the shots that he is starting to get now, Eric. Golden State is pushed up on defense.
Draymond Green was the recipient of the pass, but an offensive foul against Klay Thompson. Okoro White. Warriors have scored the last 5 points. They were down by 10. Now it's 98-93 Miami with 2:18 and counting remaining in this fourth quarter thriller between the Heat and the Warriors. Waiters on the pull-up. Air ball. Warriors have won 7 in a row and 18 of their last 20. Heat on their best win streak of the season at a modest 3 straight games. Steph Curry gets by Dragic, sends it out to Durant, looking for his first three and gets it.
Yeah, that's what happens, Eric. You suck the defense in, especially on that weak side, and then you find your shooter.
He was 0 for 6 from downtown prior to that splashdown. So 8 straight points by Golden State. The Heat are up by 2. And a timeout for Miami with 1:47 to play. The American Airlines Arena, Timmy right between Zoe and Shaq. It's a good place for a point guard. Minute 40 left, Heat lead by 2. The Warriors have scored 8 straight points.
Four
on the shot clock. And the 2, tough 3 for Waiters. Kaboom! Deion Waiters to the rescue. 30 points for Waiters. 63 points in his last two games. 101 to 96 Miami. Durant for 3. Rebound to Green. First shot clock for the Warriors. And it goes out of bounds back to Miami.
Yes.
He was playing his best basketball, but he's back in rhythm and he is back in control of the Heat offense.
Under 2 minutes, they can't have Hackershack here.
Warriors have been held under 100 points just twice all year. They lost both times. Minute 3 to play. 9 on the shot clock. Waiters leaning in, missing. Rebound to Livingston. Here comes Sean Livingston.
They have the advantage here.
Green on the lob for Durant. He bounces it in. 9 points in the quarter for Durant. 25 for the game. It's a 3-point lead for the Heat.
Deion fell down at the other end. There was a 5-on-4 in that situation for Golden State.
Tony, I don't care who takes a shot, but it's got to be a good one off ball movement. The Heat trying to self-will their way to the win. 5 on the shot clock. Waiters steps back. And maybe the Heat trying to go to the well too many times the same way. Livingston dunks. 21 seconds left. 1-point lead for the Heat. Not one-on-one. You need execution for an open shot. And instead, we get a timeout for Miami. A 20-second timeout with just under 19 seconds to play.
The spot. Gotta like that.
Waiters looking to get it in. Finds Dragic along the baseline. He was fouled by Draymond Green with 17.6 seconds left.
This really helps Steve Kerr now. Doesn't need a three here.
He last in the NBA in free throw shooting at 68%. Tonight they've missed 11 free throws. Pachulia pulling off his warm-up. He'll come into the game for the Warriors. And let's see who comes out. Going to be Klay Thompson that comes out. Klay sits with 22.
That's an interesting move. Oh, they're going to get the rebound and call timeout. That's why Thompson came out. He'll be back in the game now.
I would think so. Yes. Dragic makes the free throw. Heat lead by two. In the curve, off to Green. Cross court Durant. Fakes the shot. Drives in and jams. Kevin Durant ties the game at 102 with 11.2 seconds left.
He'd have no timeouts left. That was a good job by James Johnson running Durant off the three. The worst that happens, overtime.
In the hands of Waiters, 3 seconds left for three and the win. Yes! Dion has done it!
Oh, my.
Inbounds throw.
He can switch everything on the three-point line here.
Livingston in the Curry. Miami wins the game. Miami has defeated the Golden State Warriors 105 to 102. The best win of the season for Miami. They end the Warriors' win streak at 7. They extend their own to a fourth straight win.
Coming off perhaps their worst loss of the season a couple of nights ago in Minneapolis.
Yeah, and they started off 17 for 17 from the free throw line and now have missed their last four.
Off to a bad fourth quarter here, like they had a couple of nights ago in Minneapolis, whistling a foul against Iguodala.
Jamal Murray, the Lakers. I believe the Miami Heat can get through this entire little process as long as they keep pushing through it.
I'll tell you one thing. With Uncle Drew on the left, if Kyrie looks over his shoulder and sees Uncle Drew there, he's going to get some special inspiration. Because you remember how Uncle Drew did in that movie, right?
I actually missed that one. I saw the commercials and all that, but I missed the movie.
It was Reggie Miller's and Chris Webber's best performance.
Well, that's saying something.
Up high, the lob. Adebayo with the finish from Dragic. Lead down to four with plenty of time for Miami. Brooklyn shooting 50% from the field on the game. Irving out top. Bruce Brown on the roll, kicks it out to Harris. One more to Blake Griffin from the corner. Rebounded by Adebayo. Dragic, as Bam slipped the screen, a whistle. That's going to be a foul against Brooklyn. That'll be their fourth team foul. Miami from the field in this game. Ariza sets the screen for Dragic. Kyrie on him. The dribble handoff to Dragic. Jeff Green checked back into the ball game. And a bit of good defense by Green to force the miss.
Yeah, and much better job in that pick and roll of Kyrie getting under Bam so you don't get the opportunity for that lob.
They've got Ariza on Kyrie. Shows you the respect that Irving commands at the defensive end. Shamet working against Adebayo. Green in the corner. Shot clock down to two. Has to launch. And rebounded by Adebayo. They finish off the possession with the board. Here's Robinson. Inside, they found the mismatch. The help comes. Wide open three. Ariza off the mark. Bam trying to keep it alive. Dragic does. Ariza gets it back. Into the paint. Took the contact and got it to go with the left. And it's a two-point game.
And that's one of the advantages that the Miami Heat have. You're going to play small. Bam Adebayo getting offensive rebounds, just being a force down low, gets the Miami Heat multiple opportunities.
Adebayo switches on to Kyrie. Hit him with the quick sit dribble, but missing the mid-range jump shot. And Miami can tie it up or take the lead on a three. Under 1.5 to go. Bam double-teamed. They repost it. He faces up on Jeff Green. Robinson for the lead. And Harris clears. Kyrie over the midcourt line for Brooklyn. Iguodala this time on Irving. Last time it was Ariza. Kyrie asks for the clear out. Sidestep three. And Dragic going to push it. Takes it all the way to the bucket. Dragic knocks the game at 107
the Dragon breathing a little bit of fire.
You know, it's a tie game, so I imagine some sort of pick and roll, maybe with Kyrie, because this is a top, there's a multiple possessions here, but you know his area is that top of the key.
The kick out to Green. Thought about the three. They ran him off the line. Whistle, foul going to go against Miami and Dragic.
It was really curious that how that whole play just kind of worked itself out.
They had a foul to give.
Yeah. And that's maybe why Kyrie decided to go a little bit quicker. Jeff Green passing up the three.
Ariza back on Irving. And now Bam switches onto him. The three up in the air. Dragic with the board. 20 seconds to go. And Miami can run it down. Adebayo against Green. 8 seconds. Bam. Facing up. Gonna run it down. He goes with it. Adebayo for the win. Oh, count it. Dade County. How do you like Bam, man?
What a shot.
Charge with three of Philadelphia's 11 triples. Philly by three now. 4:15 left. Wade, 22-footer. Yes. Dwayne Wade with 14 now. Actually with 16. It's a one-point lead for Philadelphia. Under 4 minutes left. Redick back to Embiid from downtown. No good. Šarić was fouled by Olenek. Olenek's first foul, Dario Šarić. By the way, Dwayne Wade, he had 16 points. It was his high point game for Miami that came at New Orleans. He's got 16 tonight in 21 minutes.
Something a little more comfortable in this system again.
21 points now for Dario Šarić. He has their last five, and the Sixers have a three-point lead. Richardson, Dragic, Olenek, and Whiteside.
You got Wade running the point.
Simmons fouls Dwayne Wade off a good pump fake. That's number four on Ben Simmons. And I believe the fourth team foul on Philadelphia, yes. But Dwayne Wade will go to the stripe with 16 points. 11 of them in the second half.
He'll be shooting two shots.
Wade has averaged 22 minutes a game since coming back to the Heat. 23 minutes for the season. He's played 21 tonight. You know, Wade, so far, taking 11 shots a game for Miami in 22 minutes a game, which is not far off from what he was doing with Cleveland. The chance of the tiebreaker. If the Sixers win, they go up three on the Heat, and they win the season series.
Yeah, you just saw the Washington score. If you're a Heat fan, you're rooting for Washington to beat Milwaukee. They're up six right now. A couple of minutes left in that game.
18 points for Wade, six of them in the fourth quarter. It's a one-point lead for Philadelphia. 3:26 left. Embiid for three. Oh, no. 21 for Embiid. That's his third triple. Seven of the last eight Sixer field goals have been from downtown. They have 12 triples for the game. They're up by four. 3:10 left. Olenek downtown. Off target. Rebound Richardson. And he covers up with a fresh shot clock. 3 minutes left. Wade zigzags and scores.
Second chance points off Jay Rich's offensive rebound.
Eight in the quarter and his first 20-point game back in a Heat uniform. I'd stand up and cheer if I were you two.
He looks like the old Dwayne Wade right now.
Two-point lead for Philadelphia. Embiid finds Redick. This is Šarić. Now Simmons. Oh, terrible shot by Ben Simmons. Richardson to the loose ball. Down two. Here they come. Wade on the run. Tie game at 95. A 10-point fourth quarter for Wade. Well, we were tied at 87. Now we're tied at 95. This is Redick, bottled up by Richardson. And Richardson called for the foul. 14 shooter. And 10 of those points in the fourth quarter. Oh, Goran Dragic was covering Covington on a cut. Dragic was sure the foul was going to go on Covington, but no, it's the fourth on Goran and the fourth team foul on Miami.
Yeah, and the next fouls, both teams will be in the, over the limit.
Well, first two games in Philadelphia between these two clubs went right down to the wire. This one no different here in Miami. Embiid guarded by Dragic. Whiteside got screened off by Covington. Three on the shot clock. Redick, long three. And a long rebound off the body of Covington, but taken by Redick. He'll shoot a three. Get fouled by Richardson with a minute 47 left. And three free throws ahead for the NBA's second best free throw shooter, J.J. Redick.
Guys like Redick live for this moment.
J.J. Redick, two-time first-team All-American and the all-time leading scorer at Duke. He played 4 years in. Got 14 points tonight. Sixers looking for a three-point lead. Redick gives it to him.
No rim.
Money in the bank. Three-point lead for Philadelphia. Dwayne Wade has 10 straight points for Miami. Crunch time now with a minute 34 left. Going for three. In and out. And the rebound is charged. Now the Heat really need a stop. That's a huge possession. Simmons could not catch the lob. And the Heat get the ball back. Redick's lob was too high for Simmons. The 23rd turnover for the 76ers. Well, the Heat down three, get it right back with 1:17 to play. Dragic. Dragic gets it back from Hassan, looking for some space. 10 on the shot clock. Heat disorganized right now. Now they get reset. In the white side against Covington. What a great play by Dwayne Wade.
Dwayne looked up because he had Embiid guarding him. He knew that Whiteside would be open.
15 points for Whiteside. Wade's first assist. 1 point game. 45 seconds left. They're on their feet here in Miami. Embiid gets by Whiteside. Finishes. 23 points for Embiid. Timeout for Miami. Oh my. Saric knocked it free. Wade gets it back to Olenek. Richardson. Wade. 15 on the shot clock. Wade fakes the three, fires, and draws the foul on Saric. And now Dwayne Wade will shoot three free throws with the Heat down by three and 27 seconds left.
Expect Philadelphia to call timeout here. They have two left. Set up a play. That's what Brett Brown is thinking of right now. Yeah, he's saying no timeout.
Dwayne Wade does it.
He doesn't want a timeout.
Three straight free throws. Ties the game at 100. Wade has 13 of the Heat's last 15 points.
Why did Dwayne Wade foul right there?
I don't know. With the Heat over the limit, I don't
tie
get
game.
That. Oh, no.
I don't wonder,
you know,
if
there
Dwayne...
was a miscommunication. Eric Spoelstra said, if you missed one, foul.
No, you got to know that. If it's a tie game, you don't foul.
Oh, my. Ben Simmons, a 57% free throw shooter.
See if this works out to the Heat advantage. You got to get the defensive rebound here. That hasn't been a gimme for the Heat. Bolster has a timeout left. Let's see if he wants to use it.
Simmons makes one out of two. It's a one-point lead for Philadelphia with 23.8 left. And here it comes. Dwayne Wade into the offensive end with a game hanging in the balance.
And you're down one, you got to try to score, shoot as soon as possible to give yourself a chance at an offensive rebound or call timeout.
Wade against Simmons, 7 seconds left, forces one up and scores! It was a tough shot, it was a great shot! 102-101! Wade will not pressure the inbounds thrower, Simmons. He'll play free safety. Just under 6 seconds left in a one-point game. Into Redick, back to Simmons with three. He spins out to Šarić. Now Redick for the win. No! Miami wins it! 102-101! Dwayne Wade with the game winner. He's the hero!
This season. Fans don't maybe don't get to see him play as much up in the Northwest. Those, most of those games are late at night. Well, hey, this is a typical game for Aldridge. That's you know, one of the best power forwards in the league.
Dragic, contact from Lopez, no call. Here comes Batum with a Heat lead at four. 4:25 left in the game. Back to Aldridge. That one he misses. Anderson holds on to the rebound.
What did Terry Stotts tell us before the game? My team is never out of it. Our guys are never out of it.
And LaMarcus Aldridge with 20,000 Heat fans on their feet here in Miami. 4 minutes to play. The Heat lead by four. Whiteside is back in. Wade goes left. Banks it up, missed it. Whiteside gets the offensive rebound. The Heat get a fresh shot clock.
And UD is back in to guard Aldridge down the stretch here.
That's got to help. Haslam, the best choice to defend Aldridge. Wade zigging and zagging and scoring. Nobody does it like Dwayne Wade. Nobody.
Wow. You can see why he's a future Hall of Famer, why he's got three rings, one of the best two guards to ever play the game.
Batum for three. What an answer for Nick Batum. His 80th triple this season, his first tonight.
22 assists for Portland, 21 for the Heat.
And they're one away from their season average from downtown. They average 10 threes a night. They're 9 for 23 on this night. Again, Wade getting almost anywhere he wants to go with that crafty dribble. Four on the shot clock. Hassan on his way. Yes! And it counts!
Well, with the lefty hook.
Committing the foul that puts Whiteside at the stripe. Ah, trickled off. Hassan Whiteside with 12 points, 9 rebounds, and 5 blocks tonight. 2:50 left in the fourth quarter. This game has been so good.
Oh, Miller, man.
You talk about a guy that loves the ball in his hands to take big shots down the stretch. Lillard lives for moments like these. Lillard with 17 points.
Portland's got a winning record on the road, 16 and 15.
Wade from the wing. Yep.
There it is, Eric. 7 games in a row, 25 or more points.
Dwayne Wade with 26-9 here in the fourth quarter. Miami up 5 with 2:18 left. Aflalo, straightaway 3. Yep. 15 points for Aflalo. He's got 3 triples in the game.
This team does not go away, do they?
That's been a beautiful game to enjoy. Hope you are. 2 minutes left. The Heat with a 2-point lead.
And I mentioned earlier, this team's got a shot to come out of the West. They're a good team.
Wade for 3. And the rebound out of Damian Lillard. A rare 3-point attempt for Dwayne. Blazers trailing by 2. A minute 43 left. Haslam fronting Aldridge. Now retreats to a more traditional defensive position. He's a scoring machine. LaMarcus Aldridge. 32 points. 6 in the fourth quarter. We're tied at 102. A 7-2 run by Portland. Dragic on the pull-up. In and out. Rebound battle won by Aldridge. That's his 11th rebound of the game.
That was a big time rebound there because Whiteside was going for it.
That's a big time player right there. LaMarcus Aldridge, one of the best in the business. Heat have not had an answer for him tonight.
Aflalo for three. In and out. Lopez underneath. Right side underneath. Could not stop Aldridge. And Eric Spoelstra takes a timeout. LaMarcus Aldridge is taking over. NBA behind Oklahoma City's Russell Westbrook, who hoists 21 field goal attempts tonight. Well, the Trailblazers are on a 9-2 run to take this two-point lead. 45 seconds left in the game. Wade, one-hander. Yes! Dwayne Wade! Doing it big time in the fourth quarter.
Wow. It was a pick and roll with Whiteside. He got open and he made the floater. Quick shot. No one will get it back.
LaMarcus Aldridge, the go-to man. He has 8 points in the fourth quarter.
And he probably won't double him because they don't want the three-point shot.
Oh, an air ball for Aldridge. At a most inopportune time for the Trailblazers, Whiteside with his 10th rebound. We're tied at 104. 24 seconds left in the game.
Portland's over the limit, so they can't foul here. He has 1 20-second timeout left.
Here comes Wade around the Whiteside screen. The tough jumper. Yes! Dwayne Wade! You are a giant!
Oh, man.
30 points for Wade!
But Aldridge has been hot this quarter, so probably going to be both of them involved in the play.
Looking for Lillard. Now for Aldridge. Thrown into the backcourt. That should be a turnover.
No. Under 2 minutes. Oh, you know what, Eric? They made a mistake, Portland did. Under 2 minutes, you can go into the backcourt.
Now they're signaling for a review. This play got botched up big time.
Well, did that ball hit a Portland player? On the inbound?
Heat ball!
Yeah, heat ball.
Miami ball out of bounds off the Trailblazers. And what you just told our viewers.
They can throw it into the backcourt, and he has a timeout left.
Wade has it. The chase is on with C.J. McCollum, who commits the foul with just under 10 seconds left.
Now what's it? Portland's got to push the ball up the floor. I'm sure the Heat are aware that Portland has no timeouts left. So the Heat's got to switch everything at the three-point line here. Five guys got to get on the boards. There's no Whiteside in the game.
Dwayne Wade to the rescue.
No
he
fight.
Has 32. The Heat lead by four. Lillard for three. In and out. Rebound to Wade. Throws it into the air. The game's over. And the Heat have defeated the Trailblazers.
Eric, the two best back-to-back wins of the year for the Heat. Big-time win against Cleveland. Big-time win tonight against Portland.
In Sacktown against Miami. It's a four-point Kings lead. 4:42 to play. Hero on a pull-up and a splashdown. Fourth quarter time for Hero. He's got six of his 19 points in this quarter. Remember, he had the 15-point fourth quarter in Sacramento, his highest scoring fourth quarter ever on Saturday night. 4:23 to play. Herter's back in. He had vanished to the locker room moments ago. Mitchell way off from three, and the ball goes off a King out of bounds. The Heat will get it back down by two. Kings trying to win their third in a row. Miami trying to win their second straight for the first time this year. Hero. Struce sets a screen. Bam sets a screen. Hero launches. Yes.
Really good teamwork up front. Stagger screen. Two different screens. Allowed Tyler to turn the corner, get downhill for that pull-up jumper from 15 feet.
Heat have come from seven down in the fourth quarter to even the game at 96. 3:47 left. A foul on the Monk pass.
Controller can't afford to lose Bam here with a six foul.
Through the hands of Mitchell. Ball goes out of bounds on a Mitchell-Vincent collision. Eric Lewis ruling it will stay Sacramento possession. Making that call. Mitchell inbounds to Kevin Herter. This is Sabonis. Five on the shot clock. Herter back to Sabonis. He missed it. Tyler Hero with his 11th rebound. Tie game. Heat ball. A three on the way. And Barnes comes down with a rebound. The Hero's already scored 8 points in this fourth quarter. 3:15 left. Monk on the drive. The pitch for a Herter triple.
Yeah, he had a chance to load up and splash it down. Kevin Herter. Stop the Sixers' win streak at three. Porzingis had 30 for the Wizards. Beal added 29. All right, back to work. Go the Heat. Down by three. Bam, down the runway for two. Bam Adebayo. He's got 8 points in the fourth quarter, 20 for the game.
Great execution, too, on that dive cut. Bam able to finish with that athleticism.
Gorgeous assist by Lowry. It's a one-point Kings lead. Barnes missed it. No foul. Heat ball. Here comes Bam again. Remember, he's playing with five fouls. 2.5 minutes left. Heat down one. Heat on the shot clock. Bam deep in the corner. Oh, great pass for Vincent. Miami takes the lead. On the game Vincent score, we get our 26th lead change of the night.
Beautiful feed by Bam. Hitting him in rhythm with that backdoor bounce pass.
Well, late game drama for the second straight night. The Heat went down to the wire, beat the Warriors last night. Trying to get a revenge win tonight against the Kings. Vincent steals it from Monk. Gabe driving, nobody with him, so he holds up. 1:50 remaining. The Heat have the lead and the ball. Lowry driving in the paint. Pitches out. Strus for three. Yes! Max Strus with a big splash from downtown to put the Heat ahead by four.
The Strusinator.
First things first. Got to finish the deal and try to beat the Kings. Hero, Lowry, Strus, Adebayo, and Vincent on the floor for Miami. This is Mitchell in the paint for the score. Davion Mitchell with a burst and a basket. He's got 7 points. The Heat lead is down to two. Minute 25 left. Now remember what Mike Brown said? Every possession meaningful, every possession magnified. Final minute and a half of a close game. Bam. Against Sabonis. Two to shoot. Strus. Short. Bam. Back taps. But it's taken by the Kings. 1 minute to play. Through the hands of Sabonis, but backed up by Monk. He had the shot blocked by Strus. That was a big one. Under a minute left. Sabonis against Vincent. And Gabe Vincent will be whistled for the foul.
Oh, no.
He's a 68% free throw shooter this year. Domantas Sabonis. Cost him two good players, Buddy Hield and Tyrese Halliburton. We'll see both of those guys with the Pacers Friday night. But Sabonis, he was a power forward next to Miles Turner for a number of years with Indiana. He's the Kings center this year. And he makes two big free throws there. So he's got 20 points to go along with 12 rebounds and 8 assists. He's had a monster game, and he's tied the game at 103. O'Don is that 4-point lead for Miami. Hero scooping for the score. Tyler Hero. A 10-point fourth quarter tonight. He's got 23. The Heat lead it 105 to 103. Mitchell gets through, gets two. That man's a bulldog. Got 9 points, four in a row here at crunch time. Well, it's 105 apiece. Down to 30 seconds left. Lowry, pull back, jumper, yes. Kyle Lowry with a season high, 22. It's 107 to 105.
Shot making right now on display. Be tight here defensively without fouling.
Timeout to Mike Brown. Kings going with Mitchell, Barnes, Sabonis, Monk, and Herter. 3 second difference, shot clock and game clock. Monk gets to the paint, finds Sabonis, and he gets fouled underneath, but he missed the shot with 12 and a half seconds left.
That almost rimmed out.
Dwayne Dedman comes on for Miami.
He have.
And he replaces Tyler Herro.
He'd have two timeouts left. Kings, no timeouts. So Miami most likely will call a timeout here.
Interesting move there to put Dedmon in just in case there's a defensive rebound. The Heat will call a timeout after right. this to get Herro back. For the tie. He doesn't. So Sabonis does tie the game. The Heat do take a timeout. In the Herro has 10 points in the fourth quarter. 7 seconds left. Five. Herro for three. Kaboom! With 1.8 left. The Heat only needed two. Herro gave them three.
They have no timeouts. They have to go the full length of the court.
Deep to Sabonis, leans in, no whistle, offensive foul, and Bam got hit right in the face. 0.3 seconds left. In the Struce, ball game's over. Well, revenge week works out great for the Heat. Lowry using the Bam screen, lobs it in, Bam crushed it. That's the prettiest hookup of the night. Lowry put it in a perfect spot for Bam to finish. 3-point Thunder lead. Gilgeous Alexander picked up by Oladipo. That's a big shot for him. Only his second field goal of the second half. He has 23 points.
Constantly attacking off the dribble. You seal him. He just raises up. He's got that 6'6 frame and height to shoot over top.
Herro penetrates. Finds Martin for the open three. Doesn't get it. Rebound down to Aaron Wiggins. 5-point Thunder lead, just over 4 minutes left, fourth quarter. We are in punch time. Gilgeous Alexander on the spin and score. Two buckets in a row. The 24-year-old out of Toronto, who has lit up the league this year. He's the number three scorer in the NBA behind only Joel Embiid and Luka Doncic. Alexander, one of six players in the NBA, averaging at least 30. Oh, that's a big hit for Herro. Tyler Herro has set a new career high with his eighth triple.
Beautiful read there. They went under. It looked like the screen. He just stayed behind and elevated.
30 points for Herro. 3.5 minutes left. Miami trailing by four. And a blocking foul on Lowry on the drive by Dort.
Going to need some more shot making for Mr. Herro here to close this one.
Dort now at 17 for Tyler Herro, his 14th career game of 30 points or more. Three of them have come this season. It's a 5-point Thunder lead. 3:24 left here in the fourth quarter. And the Heat will talk this over. Lowry using the Bam screen. He'll fire a contested three and bury it. That's as big a shot as Miami's hit all night. The fourth triple for Lowry, his first three-pointer since the first quarter, gives him 14, cuts the deficit to two. Gilgeous Alexander blocked by Herro. Giddy for three. Josh Giddy with 9 of his 19 points in this fourth quarter. 106-101, Thunder by 5. Lowry into the paint. Ball knocked away from him out of bounds. 16 on the shot clock. Well, the Heat have tied their franchise record with a 23rd triple. Made 23 triples against Charlotte in April of 2022. That was just a year ago. Herro against Baisley with a Heat down by 5. 2:38 left. Lowry for three. No air ball. Right now, it's either three or bust for Miami. Got to have a stop here with under 2.5 minutes left. Shot clock at 7. This is Dort. Missed it. Here comes Oladipo. 3-on-3 break. Victor swerving in. Makes it impossible. Shot.
Beautiful.
10 points for Oladipo.
Right down the middle there. 3-on-2, but was able to knife his way to the basket. Looked like the Victor Oladipo of old with those slashing finishes.
Minute 50 left in the game. This is a key possession. They all are. Dort against Oladipo. Shot clock is down to 4. Gilgeous Alexander missed it. Rebound to Bam in a crowd. 1:37 to go. Heat with the ball down by 3. Kyle to the paint. Pitches out. Hero's open for three. Kaboom! Miami has even the game at 106. Tyler Hero, a 10-point fourth quarter, a 33-point game, and a career-high 9 triples.
Just
a brand-new game.
Just outstanding. The way he's playing right now, stepping up with Jimmy Butler out, shouldering that scoring load.
Oh, a steal by Martin. Hits ahead for Oladipo. Tries with Dort. Scores. Plus a foul. Oh, hail to the victor. Oladipo from defense to offense. Cannot finish off the three-point play. It's a two-point Heat lead, 108 to 106. We got a minute left in another thriller. Gildas Alexander to the paint. Lost. Out of bounds. Last touch by the Heat. Heat players asking for a review. Oladipo insisting on it. And Eric Spoelstra going to take his word for it. A timeout for the Heat. Spoelstra believes it went off the leg of the Thunder.
The ball touches Oklahoma City last prior to going out of bounds. Miami ball.
Eric Spoelstra and the Heat now 9-2 with challenges this year. 3 points. One off his season high, does have a career high 9 triples.
So he wants to use some clock here, but they don't want to wait to the last second to initiate their offense. Get some movement, get some screening. OKC going to dig in and try to play this without fouling.
Bam comes up to set a screen. Remember, he's got 5 fouls. 6 on the shot clock. Lowry, a step back through. And the rebound to Giddey. The Heat will try to protect a 2-point lead with 27 seconds left. Gilchrist Alexander on the spin. And Bam may have fouled out on that reach.
Just in time to miss one here.
25.7 seconds left. Aaron Wiggins in. Giddey out. They'll use Wiggins for his defense.
2 timeouts each team has. He'd have plenty of time here. You've got to make sure you block out on a potential miss.
We got ourselves a tie game. We also got a Heat timeout. Lowry to inbound. Loops it into the backcourt for Hero. A full shot clock for Miami. They are on their feet here at the Paycom Center. Dort defending Hero. Martin sets the screen. Come under the basket, looking to send it in. Still looking. Gets it to Alexander for the tie. No. Loose ball. No. Game's over. The Heat hold on and win. 110 to 108. That should be it. The clock has run out.
Side of Kessler there. What a finish by Victor.
Now Bam stays in the game. He only has 4 fouls, folks, not 5. 4 fouls on Bam. Hero and Oladipo also with 4 fouls. 10 on the shot clock. Hero swerving into the paint. Finds Oladipo, right corner three, short. Bam and Kessler hustle for it. Kessler called for the foul. Good 28 points for Bam. For Adebayo, 26 points for Hero, 19 for Oladipo. The Heat ahead by 5 for the second time late in this game. Heat with 2-3 zone. This is Jordan Clarkson against Oladipo. He coughed it up. Hero with the takeaway. Another stop for Victor Oladipo and the Miami defense. 3:10 left in the game. Tyler Hero. Now Bam against Kessler. Sizes him up and knocks it down. A 31-point game for Bam Adebayo. On the second night of a back-to-back, Miami playing well enough and tough enough.
Yeah, they really are. 54 points in the paint, plus 26 on top of the Jazz. That's how they've offset the 3-point shooting from the Utah side. But they've been tough and physical on both ends.
Jazz scored 70 points in the paint last night in their 1-point loss at Sacramento. That was a blue-collar basket for Jordan Clarkson. Clarkson now with 19 points. It's a 5-point Heat lead. 2:33 remaining in this fourth quarter. Edge of your seat time. Again, it's a nightly adventure, folks. Bam against the rookie Kessler. Sends it back. Hero with 2 on the shot clock. Sends it up. It rims out. Rebound of Markkanen. 9th board for Lowry Markkanen, who also has 22 points. That's defense necessary, and Struess commits the foul. Injury. Dwayne Dedman missing his third game in a row. This is Conley. Now Olynyk for three. And bam, with a great block out to keep Kessler away from him. A five-point lead and possession with under 2 minutes left here in Utah. Hero, good look at a three. Rebound to Markkanen. So Markkanen with his 14th double-double of the year. 22 points, 10 rebounds. Collides with Hero. Still going. Scoops on Bam. And that will be Bam's fifth personal foul of the game.
6-11. Markkanen, another guy who can shoot with range and handle the basketball with guard-like skills.
Markkanen from Finland, where both his parents played professional basketball. His first team all-rookie with the Chicago Bulls, spent his first 4 years there. Right now he's the number 22 scorer in the league. And in his last eight games, almost 29 points a night. And tonight he's got 24. He's cut the Heat lead to three with a minute 38 and counting left here in the fourth quarter. Hold on tight. Ball knocked out of bounds by Kessler. 13 seconds on the shot clock for the Heat. Heat have held the Jazz to 17 points in the fourth quarter after Utah put up 35 in the third. No, the Jazz are the only team in the NBA this year, by the way, to not hold any team under 100 points this year. They give up 116 a game. Eight on the shot clock. Oladipo against Olynyk for three. You bet. Victor Oladipo delivering a big-time shot there. He's got 22 points. That was his fourth triple. Gives the Heat a tiny bit of breathing room ahead by six. Conley missing the three. Markkanen missing the tip. A second time, but the third time was a charm for Markkanen. Well, the lead is four for Miami with a minute to play. 24 points, 11 rebounds for Markkanen. Oladipo went down, trying to avoid a jump ball, could not. They'll have to jump it up with his 6'11", Kelly Olynyk with... They do not. Utah gets another at bat with 53 seconds left in the game. Miami hit by four, Clarkson for three. And a rebound for Victor Oladipo. That's a big stop for Miami's defense. 40 seconds left in the game. Hero from deep outside. Short, long rebound, and a hit ahead for Clarkson. He missed the dunk, but he was fouled.
Take that shot. It's got to be Gabe or Victor, or even Struess rotating into the backcourt to prevent those types of easy pitch-outs for Utah.
That was a quick shot. Now Highsmith comes in. Vincent will come out. Clarkson back at the line, where he is just 2 of 6 in this game.
Yeah, that's really amazing. He's an 82.7% free throw shooter. I mean, it's shockingly bad.
He missed it again. Loose ball on the rebound, and Tyler Hero wrestles a three for Miami. With a Heat up by four, a loose ball and a timeout for Miami.
Good call by Spo.
Vincent taking a long look. Fires ahead for Bam. And Bam will get to the stripe on the Markkanen foul.
Good.
Seconds left, and the Heat ahead by four. It's a five-point lead now. It's only the fourth time this year the Heat have scored over 120 points. And this year, you know, the magic number has been 110 for Miami. Heat still are the lowest scoring team in the league, but when they reach 110, they've won 15 of 20 games.
Yeah, their defense really pulls through there. Two timeouts for the Utah Jazz. I would expect them to probably take one here to call a play and advance the basketball.
32 points for Bam. Loose ball rebound. Who's going to get it? It's Clarkson. Jazz down by five. He'll shoot a three.
Oh, no.
And get fouled by Gabe Vincent.
His legs out and he was flying forward. That may have been a one to potentially challenge.
Close for the Jazz in this game. Could be the most free throws the Heat have allowed in the game this year.
Somebody needs to get in and block out and be that third white jersey. There we go.
Otherwise, Clarkson could try to throw the ball off the rim to himself, but now Max is in position with Highsmith getting on the inside there. Max will box out the shooter.
Potentially damaging foul there by Vincent. Clarkson will try for his third straight free throw. He makes it. He's got 22. Eric Spoelstra does take a timeout. He'd often use this alignment to try to get a backdoor cut. They got it. Oladipo goes in. Got fouled by Conley, went head over heels.
A two-possession game. There you go, Victor.
23 points for Victor Oladipo. His 11th game this year. By far his best game this year.
Yeah, 34 minutes he's logged, too. And he's looking good, making plays at the end to get open and draw fouls.
Bounced off. Loose ball. Markkanen calls timeout. I thought he was out of bounds when he got that rebound. Olenek finds Markkanen. 8 seconds left. Markkanen spinning. Unloads a three. Air ball. And a foul on Highsmith. And Markkanen. Miami has fouled a three-point shooter, and it has cost Miami. Oh, that's stunning. He's 11 for 11. Three free throws for the tie.
Get out.
Miami will try to go the length of the court to win it in regulation. Hero with three. Hero with two. Hero gets it off for the win. Yes! 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 Happy New Year, Tyler Hero and the Heat. They win it as time expires in Salt Lake.
4:20 remaining.
A very important 4 minutes and 15 seconds left in this game for Miami.
Butler to the paint. Strus to Hero. Three on the shot clock.
Oh, that is not a good possession for Miami. Not a good possession at all. A hurried three at the end of the shot clock. Deflection by Martin. Loose ball and a foul on Caleb Martin. And that'll be his fifth foul.
3:51 left in the game. Rockets with the ball and a three-point lead.
He's trying to scramble defensively. Vincent Moore got a hand on it. Ty-Ty Washington scores. Ty-Ty Washington, 4 points in the fourth quarter. 7 for the game on the Heat, down by 5. This is the Rockets' biggest lead of the night. They've been outscored 16-9 in the final period.
Yeah, got to get Jimmy Butler engaged here. Get something going.
Oh, a missed three by Strus. Miami cannot make a three in the second half. They had 8 in the first half, just 3 trays in the second. Miami is 3-for-17 from 3 in the second half. Timeout Rockets, 3:16 left here in Miami. The Rockets with a 5-point lead on the ball. 3:13 left in the fourth quarter. This is Jayshon Tate with 8 on the shot clock. He need a stop. Jalen Green to the paint, lost it. And the ball last touched by Miami. He gets it. Gets it off. Air ball, 24-second violation on the Rockets.
Love that contest. Jimmy Butler closed and stayed tight to his body there and got the hand up to contest the shot without fouling.
So under 3 minutes to play and Miami trailing by 5.
Plenty of time here. Got to execute and then get back and set that defense.
Butler off to Hero. Now Strus driving baseline. Here's Jimmy. Oh, denied and rejected. It has been that kind of night for Jimmy Butler and the Heat offense. Jabari Smith in and out. That could have been a dagger for the Rockets. Good thing that spun out. Here's Jimmy. Jimmy didn't look like himself. He was a ferocious attacker on Wednesday against Indiana.
Situation, so he's going to get to the line for 2.
Jabari Smith picking up his 5th foul. That's just the 7th point for Jimmy Butler tonight. Always a warrior, tonight subdued. 7 points, 5 boards, 4 assists, just 2 of 8 shooting. And these are only his 3rd and 4th free throws of the game. Miami 17 out of 18 at the foul line, trailing by three with 2:24 left in the game. Again, edge of your seat time. Six on the shot clock for KJ Martin. Here's Smith setting up for a three. Air ball down to Hero. Tyler Hero's ninth rebound. Heat trailing by three. Hero driving left. Sends it out to Vincent. Here's Butler. Got contact. And he'll get two more free throws.
Oh, that's great. Get himself to the free throw line. Clock is stopped. And he can potentially get two more points here for Miami. Herrera just gets so slim when you go down the stretch. Even a young team here, inexperienced, who loses close games, all they got to do is make a shot. Miami in for another tough defensive possession. Need to clamp this one down.
Butler on Jalen Green. Shot clock is at eight. This is Tate. Back to Green. Green to the paint. Loose ball. Strus has it. 28 seconds left. Vincent. Hero for three. Kaboom! Tyler Hero gives Miami a 93-91 lead with 20 seconds left. Rockets not taking a timeout. And now they do. Tyler trying to be the hero. Your feet in your living room right now. Tate looking to get it in. Gets it to Şengün. 15 seconds left. Şengün against Bam. Put it up and missed it. Rebound Smith. He got fouled. He'll go to the line with 10.9 seconds left in the game. Twenty-one points for Jabari Smith. This one will be to try to tie the game. Haywood Highsmith comes in. Max Strus comes out. He do have two timeouts left for the tie. He doesn't. Two clutch free throws for the rookie Jabari Smith. Max Strus to inbound, gets it to Jimmy Butler. Hero guarded by Green, sets the screen. Butler doesn't use it, goes in, gets fouled. With 6.2 seconds left, I like that.
So no timeout for the Rockets. They lost it on the challenge. They have to go full court now to be able to score the basketball. So important free throw here for Jimmy to go up two, and then the Heat need to match up and set their defense.
Jimmy Butler, 8 of 8 from the free throw line. The Heat, 21 of 22 from the line, ahead by 2. No fouls here. Ty-Ty Washington ahead for Green. Green on the drive, goes in and scores! Ties the game at 95 with 7-tenths of a second left in the game. The throwing. The lob for Butler, he did it! Jimmy Butler put it in with 3-tenths of a second left and got fouled!
Oh, are you
incredible? They didn't foul. Ball game's over.
Oh,
Miami wins it 97-95. Oh. 9 straight points for Indiana. Bam underneath. That's a big score for the Heat. Bam Adebayo from Kendrick Nunn.
I like the read by Kendrick Nunn. His fourth assist, took his time, got to the right hand, drew the big man Turner. That allowed him to bounce it to Bam, and then Bam the composure to take his time and finish.
Bam's made 7 of his 9 shots. Holiday pullback three ball. Short. Rebound at Dragic with a Heat trailing by 2. 3:40 to play. Dragic wide open three. And the rebound comes down to Turner, but he lost it off his leg out of bounds. And it was the effort of Bam that caused that. That's Turner imploring his coach Nate McMillan to challenge that play. And they did reverse it. It's going to be Pacers ball with 3:34 left in the game.
Probably their biggest weak link at almost 17 turnovers a game. They do not handle the ball well in that area. And that allows teams in a really tight game to have those extra possessions.
Lamb on the pull-up. He scores. Jeremy Lamb with 14. Pacers making shots with the game on the line. They're ahead by 4. 3:15 left. seven Pacers in double figures tonight. Butler leans in, sends it out. Robinson sends one up. Kaboom! They found the right man. 18 points for Robinson on six triples in 10 tries. It's a one-point Pacers lead.
Thank you, Jimmy Butler, coming in. Immediate impact half-court-wise in their offense to set up Duncan Robinson.
Warren from the corner, missing a three. Bam, running down his 12th rebound. And what a finish. A one-point Indiana lead. 2:34 left. Butler with Warren on his back. Yes. First score of the fourth. He has 20. Miami has the lead.
And this is the advantage of having Goran Dragic come in and play early in the fourth. It makes Jimmy Butler fresh where he can make plays like that.
This is Warren spinning on Butler, who blocked the shot, but is called for the foul. And Jimmy need not react. Remember, he already has an earlier technical.
There, hit ball, but probably hit some of the hand there. That's why the officials made that call. Put Warren on the line for two.
DJ Warren with 15 points. Well, the Pacers in front by a point now. Our 17th lead change. Just under 2 minutes to go. Sabonis on the bench for Indiana. That's an 8-point game for him. Butler drives in, lost the ball, bam, found it, and put it down. Bam Adebayo with 8 points here in the fourth quarter. It's a 1-point Heat lead as we go back and forth.
Look, even the hard drive there doesn't result in a score for Jimmy Butler, but he draws the defense enough to allow Bam to come up with the offensive rebound here. This is what Jimmy does. He's forcing Warren to commit to him, the shot blocker, Turner, and that gives Bam, again, the easy catch and finish around the basket. 18. Butler continues to put his fingerprint on the game.
Sorry, John, there's Holiday. It bounces off. Butler bouncing high for the rebound. Bam Adebayo, 18 points, 12 rebounds, 5 assists. He's made 8 of his 10 shots. He's had another monster game. 1-point lead in the ball. Butler probing, finding Dragic from downtown. Bam sends it back to Butler. What a play by Adebayo. Butler gets by Warren, draws the foul. No, an offensive foul on Jimmy Butler. Ed Malloy making the call. Nunn and Robinson. This is Aaron Holiday. Bam around the screen, fires, and misses. Rebound to Bam, the Heat up by one. 14th rebound for Bam. Miami, 21 more rebounds than Indy. Here's Butler, drives, misses. Rebound to Warren with 38 seconds left. Pacers have a chance to reclaim the lead. Lamb against Nunn. Puts it in. Jeremy Lamb with a take charge drive. He has 6 in the fourth quarter, and the Pacers are on top. It's our 19th lead change of this incredible game. This time, Duncan Robinson is the late game inbounds man. Gets it to Butler. The Heat down by a point. Jimmy Butler drives on TJ Warren, takes it into the paint, and missed it. Loose ball rebound, fought for. Butler has it. 18 seconds left in the game. Here's Nunn, drives in, and misses it. Butler misses the tip. Bam gets it back, 11 seconds left. Down to 9, Dragic with a left. Got it! He got it! 113, 112, 6.8 left. Dragic puts Miami ahead.
Put it on the floor multiple times and get to the basket. They don't have to take a three.
Game about to be decided in the hands of Aaron Holiday. With 3, Holiday with a spin, with a flip, he missed it. The Heat win. Miami wins 113 to 112. After them, well, the Wizards ahead by 4, 4:45 left in the game. Taylor Johnson with a two-handed steal. Here comes Richardson. Magruder sets up for the triple. Kaboom! Rodney Magruder with his first NBA 20-point game. He has three trays. The Heat are down by one.
How about seven boards and six assists and just nasty and hard nose on the defensive end, too, Herb?
Here's Beal. Misses the three. Magruder able to deflect the rebound to Whiteside. Well, the Heat are down one, half a rock. Richardson. Dragic driving past Morris. Throws on the brakes. Ball deflected out by Otto Porter with five left on the shot clock. Right after the game. Quick shot by Tyler Johnson with a shot clock winding down. And the loose ball rebound to Otto Porter. Wizards still ahead by one. Good defense by Magruder. Porter misses. Whiteside secures his 11th rebound of the game. And a chance for the Heat to reclaim the lead. Richardson's three. Does it. Josh Richardson. A 10-point fourth quarter and a 25-point game. 21 shots last night. He has taken 20 shots tonight. Has 25 points. Most importantly, 10 of those points here in the final quarter. Beal gets in, got the field goal and the foul. And Richardson got hit hard.
6'5 and some strength to be able to take a hit and finish as well.
A three-point play for Beal gives him 18, gives the Wizards a one-point lead. ...107-106 with just over 3 minutes left. Dwayne Wade's back in for closing time. Wade finds Dragic, the corner triple. In and out. Rebound to Morris. Outlet to Wall. Racing into the front court and drawing a foul on Rodney Magruder. That's number five on Magruder.
Almost creating a human wall around the paint, and it's not just the guy guarding him. The rest of the guys have to shade off their men, run back, get there early. John Wall, one of the best in the league at getting out in transition and forcing defenses to react to him.
Wizards have already missed 10 free throws in this game. John Wall, he looks just as good as ever tonight. 24 points, 9 assists.
Defense!
A 2-point Washington lead with 2:50 left in the game. Well, two games, two thrillers. Wade against Beal. Richardson into the paint. Got fouled. Josh Richardson with a new mode, that assertive takeover mindset.
For a 6'10 guy, use your foot speed, get around him, and get inside where good things can happen around the rim or drawing fouls.
You know, no fan base is ever really happy with officiating. They have something in common with coaches. But just for the sake of balance, the Wizards with 30 fouls tonight, Miami with 25. So for those of you feeling that the Heat are not getting a good whistle here in Washington, a little data.
And a lot of fouls being called because of this freedom of movement point of emphasis.
18th tie of the game, doesn't last long. Beal on the lob, able to finish. Well, Bradley Beal has 20. He and Wall have combined for 44 for the Wizards. They're ahead by two, 2:15 left. Well, a team that wins this game might be the team that has the ball last.
Tip continues to develop. This is their seventh straight year, Eric, of them being able to play together. You can just see that internal chemistry continues to improve.
They got
to
be one of the premier backcourts in the NBA again this year. Miami getting a miss from Richardson at the stripe. Second one is good. Josh Richardson with 28 points. 13 in this quarter. It's a one-point lead for Washington. 2:07 to go. Beal down the lane. Whiteside got it. Second block in the fourth quarter for Hassan. He trailing by one. Dragic probing, bouncing for Dwayne, who scores. Wade, first score of the fourth quarter, gives Miami a one-point lead. 111 to 110. This is Morris, open three. And the rebound of Dwayne Wade. Seventh rebound for Dwayne. A good position for Miami. The ball and the lead with a minute 25 to go. The Heat bench on their feet. Five on the shot clock. Nothing happening. Backdoor cut, Dragic. Two to shoot. Wall got a piece of it. And a 24-second violation results on what turned out to be a disorganized possession.
Yeah, in that particular situation there, J. Rich can't pick up his dribble. He's got to keep pounding it, keep the play alive there. He's got to be the one making the play to shoot or pass.
What a game. 19 lead changes, 18 ties, and a minute left. Okay, here's a switch you don't like. Whiteside guarding Wall. And Whiteside fouls John Wall. 7 free throw attempts. Well, 28-year-old John Wall, top pick in the 2010 draft after a season at Kentucky. He makes them both. And the Wizards go in front by one, our 20th lead change. Now the Heat need the score to take the lead back. Richardson's pass gets deflected. Whiteside picks it up off the floor. Morris ties him up for a jump ball. Magruder and Richardson, and that's exactly where he goes with it. Four on the shot clock. And what's the call? Timeout, Miami. Scott Brooks wanted a double dribble. Miami gets the timeout with 33 seconds left in the game. Richardson, Dragic, and Whiteside. Richardson with one to shoot, drives all the way in. And it is another 24-second violation. The ball never got to the rim. The 19th turnover on Miami gives it back to the Wizards. They lead by one with just over 30 seconds left.
I don't think it's a bad attempt, though. I like the fact that he put it down on the deck. Maybe should have looked for the runner there, but still a solid attack there by Jay Rich.
The Heat need a stop. A six-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Now everybody here at the Capital One Arena on their feet. Wall with the ball. Six on the shot clock. Wall for three. And the rebound to Wade with 6.6 seconds left. Another timeout for Miami. Down one with the ball, 6.6 left. Wade turns, fires for the win. Olenek puts it in with 0.2 seconds left. And the Heat take the lead, 113 to 112. Boom, all you want. He may have just delivered the Heat a win.
Derrick Jones Jr. be the pogo man right now.
He blocked it. He deflected it. Ball game's over. And the Heat have won here in Washington. A game-winning putback by Olenek. A game-saving deflection by Derrick Jones Jr. The Heat get their first victory of the season in game number two.
1-point lead for the Pistons. 4:24 left on the fourth quarter clock.
There's a resilient team.
Richardson with 8 on the shot clock. Gets some room and misses it. Whiteside brings down the rebound. Drummond with some excellent defense. The Heat still trail by 1. Ish Smith with 4:05 left in the game. We are in crunch time now. Seven on the shot clock for Detroit. Down the 4. Harris against James Johnson, 2 to shoot. And the rebound to Dragic. Excellent defensive possession for Miami. Down 1 with the ball, 3:40 to go. Feels like playoff pressure on both clubs. Magruder drives in for the hook and scores. First field goal of the second half for Rodney. He has 12. And we have our 6th lead change of a very important and competitive game.
And left-hand hook.
Well, that ended the 6 straight points by the Pistons. Caldwell Pope steps back, leans in, and draws the foul on Richardson. They're going to have to review this to see if it was a 2 or a 3.
I think it was.
A
Pistons are 13 of 17 at the stripe tonight. Remember, they're not a good free throw shooting team. They're 21 now for Caldwell Pope as Josh Richardson leaves the lineup. Tyler Johnson is in. Richardson scored 7 of his 9 points in the first half. But Caldwell Pope gets 2 out of 3, puts the Pistons in front by 1 with 3:11 left in the game. Oh, Dragic felt pressure and then passed it off when he did draw the foul. The Pistons are over the limit. Hardaway shared the news with us today. Not great news. He was notified by the Hall of Fame that he's not getting in this time around. Hey, stay tuned, gang, for the Heat Live postgame presented by Ram with Will Manso and John Crotty. They'll have the highlights, the stats, and all the analysis of this big game from the AT&T Fox Sports Studio. You'll also hear sound from the Heat locker room and from Heat head coach Eric Spoelstra. Dragic gets both, puts the Heat in front by 1. Dragic with 25. 2:50 left in the fourth quarter. And back and forth we swing. Ish Smith missed the bank shot, but a late foul. And it's against Tyler Johnson.
See the right hand on the body of Smith. That's what the Mark Davis saw, called the foul. Sometimes players aren't aware that they even did that.
16 points for Ish Smith. Pistons, 80% free throwing tonight, 16 for 20. We're tied at 91. And we stay tied at 91 as Whiteside brings down his A3 down. 2:40 left. Dragic back to Magruder. 7 on the shot clock. 4 to shoot. Dragic open for 3. Short. And the rebound to Harris hits ahead for Stanley Johnson. And an offensive foul on Stanley Johnson. Dragic takes the Heat's 3rd charge of the game.
Boy, what a good play by Dragic. He shot the ball, then he had to get back defensively. He got in front of that restricted area and took the hit. It's a big play in this game. Yeah, he was there.
2:15 left on the fourth. Great play by Dragic. Cut off the angle for Stanley Johnson. Heat need a good look. Did not get one last possession.
Yeah, the Heat are getting stuck on the perimeter here.
7 on the shot clock. Dragic against Caldwell Pope. Back to Whiteside. 3 on the shot clock. And Drummond commits the foul. So the game tied, Whiteside at the line. 14.8 rebounds. Miami's missed 8 free throws, or 18 for 26. He makes the second. First point of the fourth quarter for Whiteside gives the Heat a 1-point lead with a minute 50 to play. Yes, Smith guarded by James Johnson. Magruder's on Harris with 8 on the shot clock. Tobias on the turn, missed it. Drummond couldn't hold on to the rebound. Heat have the ball and a lead of 1. Oh, this sets up as a huge possession for Miami. Dragic gets it back from Tyler Johnson. Tyler, short, rebound Magruder. Fresh shot clock for the Heat. That's a huge rebound for Rodney Magruder.
He's got 3 timeouts left, Eric. 1 full and 2 20s.
Miami needs a score with a minute 5 to go and a 1-point lead. Dragic almost stepped out of bounds. Here comes Magruder against Harris. Tough shot. And the rebound comes down to Caldwell Pope. Pistons trailing by 1. 49 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Caldwell Pope for 3. It's good. He's got two triples, his only two triples of the game here in the fourth quarter. He had missed his first seven.
Their defender off the dribble.
Right now, this sets up as the biggest possession of the game for Miami, and Magruder turns it over on the inbound.
Oh, my. Now you got to get it. He tripped as he came off. Now you've got to get a stop.
That's Miami's sixth turnover of the fourth quarter. They had committed just seven turnovers through the first three quarters. Now pressure on the defense. Miami needs a stop here with just under 44 seconds left. Andre Drummond goes out. Aaron Baines comes in.
Well, Drummond's a bad foul shooter. That's why he goes out.
Well, the fourth quarter turnovers have been killers for Miami. 32 seconds left in the game. Smith makes it. Timeout Heat. James Johnson looking to get it in.
Technical foul on the defender.
Dragic makes the technical free throw. So it's 96 to 93. Dragic with 26 points. Miami still has the ball, down by three with 30 seconds left. Johnson, having trouble getting it in, bounces to Dragic. Goran leans in and rolls it in. A three-point possession for Goran Dragic. And Miami down by one now, 96 to 95.
Try to put pressure on them. You try to get the possession.
Loose ball. Oh, Magruder was battling for it with Harris. It's a kick on Rodney Magruder. Yeah. In the Caldwell poke. How long do the Heat wait before fouling? Into Stanley Johnson. He's double-teamed. And we get a jump ball. A jump ball with 14.7 seconds to play. Right here. Johnson wins the tip. And here comes Dragic. Stolen away by Caldwell Pope, who was out of bounds. They got to get the ball in
there. Going to James Johnson. James Johnson is the guy who's going to get it.
Oh, my. Throws it deep into the backcourt. With 10 seconds left, here we go, game's on the line. James Johnson, the pull-up jumper. Whiteside misses the tip, 3 seconds left. Dragic puts it up. Whiteside tips it in, and the Heat win the game. Whiteside wins the game for Miami. The Heat win it, their first one-point victory of the season.